Okay, good morning everyone and good evening to some of our participants. ঠিক আছে মৰমৰ ছাত্ৰ-ছাত্ৰীসকল আৰু ইয়াত উপস্থিত আন গণিত প্ৰেমী ৰাইজ, আজি আমাৰ 15 মিনিট শিক্ষাৰ যিটো প্লেটফৰ্ম তাৰ আমাৰ আজি প্ৰথম মেথমেটিক্সৰ লেকচাৰ। আজি এই প্ৰথম লেকচাৰটো দিব আমাৰ গুৱাহাটী IIT-ৰ গণিত বিভাগৰ অধ্যাপক অনুপম শইকীয়াদেৱে। গতিকে অনুপম শইকীয়াদেৱে এই ভাষণটো বা এই লেকচাৰটো দিয়াৰ আগতে মই তেখেতৰ বিষয়ে অলপ চমুকৈ কৈ ল'ব বিচাৰিছো। আচলতে অধ্যাপক অনুপম শইকীয়াক অসমৰ গণিত জগতৰ ল'ৰা ছোৱালীয়ে হওক বা বাকী শিক্ষক শিক্ষয়িত্ৰীয়ে হওক তাৰ লগত তেনেকে পৰিচয় কৰি দিয়াৰ সিমান এটা প্ৰয়োজন নাই। অধ্যাপক অনুপম শইকীয়াৰ নামটো অসমত খুব বহুলভাৱে প্ৰচলিত আৰু প্ৰায় সকলোবিলাকে জানে। আনকি স্কুল কলেজৰ বহুত ঠাইত মই দেখিছো যে অধ্যাপক অনুপম শইকীয়াৰ নামটো বহুত কুইজৰো উত্তৰ। তথাপিতো মই খুব চমুকে অনুপম শইকীয়াৰ বিষয়ে অলপ ক'বলৈ ওলাইছো। যে অনুপম শইকীয়াই যে হাই স্কুল পৰীক্ষা পাছ কৰিছিলে 1979 চনত গোলাঘাট চৰকাৰী উচ্চতৰ মাধ্যমিক বিদ্যালয়ৰ পৰা। তাৰপাছত তেখেত কটন কলেজলৈ আহিলে। কটন কলেজৰ পৰা 1979 আৰু 1991 সেই দুটা বছৰত তেওঁ উচ্চতৰ মাধ্যমিক পৰীক্ষাত সুকলমে পাছ কৰি খুব উচ্চ উচ্চ পাৰ্চেণ্টেজত তেওঁ দিল্লীৰ ছেণ্ট ষ্টিফেন্স কলেজলৈ যায়। ছেণ্ট ষ্টিফেন্স কলেজত অংক বিষয়ত অনাৰ্ছ লৈ তেওঁ 1996 চনত অনাৰ্ছ লৈ তেওঁ তাৰ পৰা পাছ কৰে। অনাৰ্ছত তেওঁ ছেণ্ট ষ্টিফেন্স কলেজৰ আটাইতকৈ মেথমেটিক্স। অকল সেইটোৱে নহয় যে সেই বছৰত যে আমাৰ ভাৰতবৰ্ষৰ পৰা প্ৰতি বছৰে কেম্ব্ৰিজত পঢ়িবৰ কাৰণে এজন এজন মাত্ৰ বছৰত এজন এজন ল'ৰাক স্কলাৰশ্বিপ দিয়া হয়, ৰামানুজন স্কলাৰশ্বিপ। গতিকে সেই বছৰত অনুপম শইকীয়াই সেই ৰামানুজন স্কলাৰশ্বিপটো পাই কেম্ব্ৰিজলৈকে যাত্ৰা কৰে। গতিকে আমি এটা কথা ক'ব পাৰো যে সেই বছৰৰ গোটেই ভাৰতবৰ্ষৰ ভিতৰতে দা বেষ্ট মেথমেটিক্স গ্ৰেজুৱেট ৱাজ অনুপম শইকীয়া। কেম্ব্ৰিজত গৈ তেওঁ তাত যিটো কেম্ব্ৰিজৰ ট্ৰিনিটি কলেজৰ যিটো ট্ৰিনিটি কলেজত তাত তেওঁ মেথমেটিক্স অধ্যয়ন কৰে। আৰু ট্ৰিনিটি কলেজৰ পৰা 1996 চনত তেওঁ যে মেথমেটিক্সত ফাৰ্ষ্ট ক্লাছ লৈ অনাৰ্ছ ডিগ্ৰী লাভ কৰে। গতিকে মেথমেটিকৰ সেইটো আমি মেথমেটিক্স ত্ৰিপোজ বুলি কোৱা হয়, যে মেথমেটিক্স ত্ৰিপোজ বা ৰেংলাৰ। সেই ৰেংলাৰটো হৈছে আচলতে ইংলেণ্ডত যিটো কোৱা হয় যে হায়েষ্ট এচিভেবল ইণ্টেলেকচুৱেল এচিভমেণ্ট। গতিকে ৰেংলাৰটো খুব এটা বিৰল সন্মান আৰু আমাৰ অসমত মই জনাত আৰু মই বোধ কৰো আই এম চিয়'ৰ যে অনুপম শইকীয়াই প্ৰথম ৰেংলাৰ। চ' এবাউট দিছ ইউ আৰ ভেৰি প্ৰাউড অফ হিম। তাৰপিছত তেখেতে আৰু এবছৰ পাছত যে তোমাৰ যে চাৰ্টিফিকেট ফৰ এডভান্স ষ্টাডি ইন মেথমেটিক্স, চ' যিটো কৰিলে তেওঁ গৱেষণা কৰিবৰ কাৰণে চাৰ্টিফিকেট পায়, সেইটো কৰিলে সেইটো কাৰণত কয় মেথমেটিক্স ত্ৰিপোজ পাৰ্ট 3। দেন হি 2001 চনত তাৰপিছত তেওঁ তাত মেথমেটিক্সৰ গৱেষণাত যোগদান কৰে যে এজন বিখ্যাত প্ৰফেচাৰ জন কোচ নামৰ এজন বিখ্যাত প্ৰফেচাৰৰ তলত। আৰু 2001 চনত তেওঁ কেম্ব্ৰিজৰ পৰা যে মেথমেটিক্সত PhD ডিগ্ৰী লাভ কৰে। তেওঁ তেওঁ ডিপাৰ্টমেণ্ট অফ পিয়'ৰ মেথমেটিক্স এণ্ড মেথমেটিকেল ষ্টেটিষ্টিক্স ইউনিভাৰ্চিটি অফ কেম্ব্ৰিজৰ পৰা তেওঁৰ থেচিছৰ টাইটেল আছিল ইয়াৰ্ছৰ থিয়ৰি অফ লিউবাৰ্ট ডিভিজন টাৱাৰ্ছ এণ্ড পিৰিয়ডিক এল এফ ফাংচন। এইবিলাক নাম আচলতে মই নিজেও কেতিয়াও শুনা নাই, মেথমেটিক্সৰ গণিতৰ ইমান টান বিষয়। এই PhD কৰাৰ পাছত অনুপম শইকীয়াই যে দুটা তিনিটামান পোষ্ট ডক্টৰেল ফেলোশ্বিপ পায়। যে প্ৰথমটো হৈছিলে তেওঁ ফ্ৰান্সৰ IHES এখন বিখ্যাত ইনষ্টিটিউট, তাৰ ছাৰ উইলিয়াম হটগে ফেলো হিচাপে 2001 পৰা 2002 চনলৈকে থাকে। তাৰপাছত তেওঁ কানাডাৰ মেকগিল ইউনিভাৰ্চিটিত 2002 পৰা 2004 চনলৈকে CRM ISM পোষ্ট ডক্টৰেল ফেলো হিচাপে থাকে। তাত আকৌ 2003 পৰা 2004লৈকে প্ৰায় একেটা সময়তে পোষ্টটোৰ লগত কনকাৰেণ্ট হিচাপে কনকৰ্ডিয়া ইউনিভাৰ্চিটিত তাত ৰিচাৰ্চ এছিষ্টেণ্ট প্ৰফেচাৰ হিচাপে থাকে। তাৰপাছত তেওঁ ভাৰতলৈ গুচি আহে যে 2004 চনত তেওঁ বম্বে IIT-ত এছিষ্টেণ্ট প্ৰফেচাৰ হিচাপে যোগদান কৰে। 2005ৰ পৰা এতিয়ালৈকে তেওঁ গুৱাহাটী আই আই টিৰ গণিত বিভাগত আছে। গুৱাহাটী আই আই টিত প্ৰথমতে এছিষ্টেণ্ট প্ৰফেচাৰ হিচাপে 5 বছৰ, তাৰপাছত এছ'চিয়েট, আৰু বৰ্তমান তেওঁ গুৱাহাটী আই আই টিৰ প্ৰফেচাৰ। আৰু এইখিনি সময়তে তেওঁ ডিন বা আই আই টি কোঅৰ্ডিনেটৰৰ বিভিন্ন ধৰণৰ কামো কৰি গৈছে। গতিকে অনুপম শইকীয়াৰ বিষয়ে আচলতে আৰু বহুত কৈ থাকিব পাৰি, মই সিমানবিলাক কথা তোমালোকক ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলক ক'বলৈ নাযাওঁ। কিন্তু তোমালোকক মই এটা বস্তুৱে কওঁ যে অনুপম শইকীয়াই যিটো এচিভমেণ্ট কৰিছে, এই যে ৰেংলাৰ ট্ৰিনিটি, তোমালোকৰ আজি এই গণিতৰ লেকচাৰটো শুনাৰ লগে লগে যাতে তোমালোকৰ মনতো সেই ধৰণৰ কথাবিলাক বা সেইবিলাক ইনষ্টিটিউট যে অক্সফৰ্ড, কেম্ব্ৰিজ, হাৰ্ভাৰ্ড, এইবিলাকত পঢ়াৰ ভাৱটো যাতে তোমালোকৰ আহে, তোমালোকৰ যাতে এটা তেনেকুৱা এটা উদ্যম বা তেনেকুৱা এটা ইনস্পিৰেশ্যন তোমালোকে এই টপটোৰ পৰা পোৱা। অনুপম শইকীয়া অকল যে মেথমেটিক্সতে ইমান বিখ্যাত বা তেওঁ অকল যে গণিত বা অংকই অনুপত কৰি থাকে তেনেকুৱা নহয়। কিন্তু তোমালোকে হয়তো ভাবিছা যে অনুপম শইকীয়াই কেৱল অংক কৰিয়ে থাকে ৰুমৰ ভিতৰত। অনুপম শইকীয়াই খেলা ধূলাটো সমানে পাৰ্গত। অনুপম শইকীয়াই বেডমিণ্টন, ক্ৰিকেট, কেৰম এই গোটেইবিলাকতে পাৰ্গত। তেওঁ ছেণ্ট ষ্টিফেন্স কলেজত 3 বছৰ একেৰাহে কেৰম চেম্পিয়ন আছিলে ফ্ৰম 1991 to 1994 ছেণ্ট ষ্টিফেন্স কলেজত কেৰম চেম্পিয়নশ্বিপ। তাৰপিছত তেওঁ ট্ৰিনিটি কলেজৰ বেডমিণ্টন টীমৰ কেপ্টেইন আছিলে, কেপ্টেইন অফ দ্য ট্ৰিনিটি কলেজ বেডমিণ্টন টীম ফ্ৰম 1998 to 1999। মেম্বাৰ অফ ট্ৰিনিটি কলেজ BA ক্ৰিকেট টীম, তাৰ ক্ৰিকেট টীমৰো মেম্বাৰ আছিলে এবছৰ 1998 to 1999। মেম্বাৰ অফ ছেণ্ট ষ্টিফেন্স কলেজ চেছ টীম, এখেৰে তেওঁ চেছো খুব ধুনীয়া খেলে। তাৰপিছত উইনাৰ অফ দ্য কেৰম ডাবলছ কম্পিটিশ্যন হেল্প ফৰ IIT কেম্পাছ ৰেচিডেণ্ট 2012ত। গতিকে অনুপম শইকীয়াই অকল মেথমেটিক্সৰ বা গণিতৰ জগতখনতে তেওঁ বিচৰণ কৰি নাথাকে, তেওঁ খেলা ধূলা, ক্ৰিকেট, বেডমিণ্টন, চেছ, কেৰম এই আটাইবিলাকতে তেওঁৰ এটা ইণ্টাৰেষ্ট, এটা ভাৰ্চেটাইল ইণ্টাৰেষ্ট এটা আছে। গতিকে মই আজি তোমালোকক ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলক বিশেষভাৱে অনুৰোধ কৰিম যে তোমালোকে অকল গণিতৰ এই বিষয়টোৰ ওপৰত কথাই নহয়, যে তেওঁ যিধৰণে এখন গোলাঘাটৰ পৰা সৰু ঠাই এখনৰ পৰা গৈ এনেকুৱাকে কেম্ব্ৰিজত, কেম্ব্ৰিজত, ইংলেণ্ডত, ফ্ৰান্সত, কানাডাত, বিভিন্ন ঠাইত, আৰু পৃথিৱীৰ বিভিন্ন দেশৰ বিভিন্ন ইউনিভাৰ্চিটিত তেওঁ ইনভাইটেড স্পিকাৰ হিচাপে তেওঁ বহুত টক দিছে ইতিমধ্যে। সেইবিলাক গোটেইবিলাকৰ কথা তোমালোকক উল্লেখ নকৰোঁ, কিন্তু তোমালোকক তাই কৈছো যে তেওঁ যিটো আদৰ্শৰে যিধৰণে আগবাঢ়ি গ'ল, তোমালোকে এই লেকচাৰটো শুনাৰ লগে লগে তোমালোকৰ মনতো তেনেকুৱা এটা যে আশা, যে সেই যে এটা প্ৰেৰণা, সেই বস্তুটো যাতে তোমালোকৰ মনত জাগি উঠে। যে আমাৰ গোটেই এই 15 মিনিট শিক্ষাৰ উদ্দেশ্যটো হৈছে সেইটো কেৱল তোমালোকক গণিত, ফিজিক্স, কেমেষ্ট্ৰি এইবিলাকৰ জ্ঞান দিয়াটোৱে নহয়, যে তোমালোকক কি ধৰণে আমি মটিভেট কৰিব পাৰোঁ গোটেই জীৱন জুৰি, গোটেই ছাত্ৰ জীৱন জুৰি সময়খিনিত তোমালোকে কেনেকে অল দ্য টাইম তোমালোকে মটিভেটেড হৈ থাকিব পৰা, ইনস্পিৰেটেড হৈ থাকিব পৰা, সেইটোৱে আমাৰ এটা প্ৰধান উদ্দেশ্য। গতিকে এইখিনি কৈয়ে মই অনুপম শইকীয়াক এই আমাৰ ইয়াত আহি লেকচাৰটো দিয়াৰ কাৰণে ধন্যবাদ জ্ঞাপন কৰিছোঁ। গতিকে অনুপম শইকীয়াক মই আহ্বান জনাইছোঁ। প্ৰফেচাৰ অনুপম শইকীয়া, প্লিজ ডেলিভাৰ ইউৰ লেকচাৰ্ছ। থেংক ইউ অল।
মই প্ৰথমতে সকলোকে আদৰণি জনাইছোঁ এই টকটোলৈ। চ' আই ৱেলকাম এভৰি ওৱান টু দিছ ছেশ্যন, এণ্ড আই উড লাইক টু থেংক প্ৰফেচাৰ পৱন চহৰীয়া ছাৰ। একচুৱেলি হি টট আছ এট কটন কলেজ, ষ্টাডিং দেয়াৰ এজ এ ষ্টুডেণ্ট অফ হায়াৰ ছেকেণ্ডেৰী, এণ্ডলি এ গ্ৰেট
নাই।
অ'কে, চ' আই এম নট চিয়'ৰ ৱেডাৰ ইউ okay I think now it is fine.
Yeah, you are audible now.
Okay, now it is fine. Yeah, Okay, so I'm not sure whether you heard me earlier, so I welcome you all to this interaction. And I'm thankful to Pavan Soria sir for his introduction, very kind introduction. And also I'd like to thank Rifadda and all others, Hiranoda, everyone associated with 15 Minute Hikka. I think it's a nice initiative, and that's why I also joined it somewhat later than others. The others were more active from the beginning. And today it is more like an interaction, but maybe I will just review what I presented in my 15 minute video, and then I will if you have any questions or discussions or any point that you, I mean, I would want you to participate, because that is the purpose of this session. Because what I had to say from myself already, I put it in the video, although in a concise way. And also, I think I will speak partly in Assamese, partly in English, because I see that participants are a bit mixed. So not everyone may understand Assamese. So, but later on, maybe after, I guess this session will go on beyond 11. So maybe later on, I'll speak more in Assamese. And to start with, I will say most of the things in English, but certain things I will try to explain in Assamese as well. Okay, so let me first share those slides also. That will make my task a bit easier. So let's see. Let me just share the screen first. Okay, can you see the slide?
Yes, yes sir.
Okay, fine. Yeah. And
yes,
maybe,
sir.
And maybe I can make it full view. Let me just see. Is the size fine? This size is fine? Or maybe I should...
Yeah, you can make it full screen, Anupam.
Okay, I'll make it slide, so maybe, yes. Okay, but it auto plays, I guess. Okay, wait. Okay, maybe I'll go like this. Okay, yeah, so what I talked about in my video is prime numbers. And to talk about prime numbers, we are all familiar with natural numbers, swabhavik sankhya. So numbers that we use for counting, like 1, 2, 3 onwards. And there's a famous mathematician, or I should say there was, Kronecker, named Kronecker, who said that God created natural numbers and everything else is the creation of man. In other words, like whatever theorems, all these discoveries in mathematics, they are basically work of man, but yeah, the numbers themselves, he attributed to God. So his thought process was like that. And because mathematics starts with numbers. And so number theory in that sense is the oldest branch of mathematics. And even Babylonians and Egyptians, they thought about numbers. And they are like clay tablets of Mesopotamia, where like things were can be found even now. Those like they calculated square root of 2, etc. I mean, they calculated square roots much before. Okay, so thousands of years ago. Okay, and then of course the significant contribution from Pythagoras. Okay, because we all know that Pythagoras theorem: a square plus b square equal to c square. If a, b, c are sides of a right-angled triangle. So that was like 600 BC, before birth of Christ. And he also proved that root 2 is an irrational number. So that is like attributed to Pythagoras. But I think Pythagoras and his disciples, they were a bit secretive. So they did not, I think, share their knowledge with everyone. That's what we get to read. And it was Euclid actually who wrote down many things. Like there's a famous volume, I mean, a collection of books on mathematics called Elements. And those books contributed very significantly, not just to geometry, but also to number theory. like all these parallel lines, they never intersect, all those things. I mean, Euclidean geometry, we probably all know the term Euclideo geometry. So it goes back to Euclid 300 years before birth of Christ. Okay, but yeah, so that is the little bit of history. And I think Euclid's books, like they were the ones which mathematicians studied later on, even after 1500 or 2000 years also, because the content there was so valuable. Okay, so prime numbers, we all know what prime numbers are, that a natural number P is called a prime number or molik hoinkha if it cannot be written as product of two smaller natural numbers. In other words, it has exactly two factors, one and itself, but only one factor will not do. For example, one, it's not a prime number, but two onwards, these are prime numbers, 2, 3, 5, etc. Okay. And of course, we know that numbers which are not primes, we call them composite. But this talk is about prime numbers. And as I said, I'm just reviewing what I said before, but maybe at a slower pace and with some more information or background. Before I take your questions or we carry on with our discussions. So why prime numbers are so important, that is due to this fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay, what is that? That every natural number n bigger than 1 can be written as a product of prime numbers uniquely up to ordering of the factors. So this is fundamental, because any natural number we can factorize. So basically it is the prime numbers that we have to understand. Okay, so they are the building blocks. Okay, this is something that we all know, that jikunu eta swabhavik sankha molik sankha puron phol gotike swabhavik sankha bujibole hole molik sankha bujibo lagibo ar molik sankha somonde bahutu prashna monole ahibo pare. There are a lot of questions to be asked about primes, some of which can be answered easily, but some of are very difficult to answer. So people have answered some questions, so I'll present some of those questions and some other questions which people are still looking for solutions. Okay, so first thing that is natural to ask is that how many prime numbers are there. And as I said, Euclid gave a very beautiful argument that there are infinitely many primes, and this proof can be appreciated by almost everyone. Even school students can appreciate this. And the essence of the proof we can find in this simple example, because you all probably know that mathematical statements, probably we should look at examples first to get the feel, and then we should look at the proof. That is one way to study mathematics, that you always look for examples. If you have some argument, abstract argument, try to apply it to some small cases. In this case, let's take, suppose we know three primes. Now, can I produce a fourth one out of these three? So how do we do that? You take the product of these three primes, 2, 3, and 5, and add 1 to it. Why do I add 1 to it? Because then it will be not divisible by 2, 3, or 5. Because each of them will leave remainder 1. That means 31 is either itself a prime. If it is not a prime, then it would be divisible by some new prime. Okay? Because by fundamental theorem of arithmetic, 31 will be factorizable into primes. Okay, it's not 1, it will be factorizable. So either it is a prime or its factors will give a prime. But since 31 is a very small number, we can directly check that it's a prime number. But this argument shows that if you give me 30 primes, I'll produce the 31st prime. Or if you give me 1,000 primes, I'll take product of all these 1,000 primes and add 1. Then that number will not be divisible by this previous 1,000 primes. So it will give us either itself is a new prime or a factor which is a new prime. So this is essentially what we write, that if P1 up to PN are the known primes, then you take product of all gute kita puran kori lobo laibo p1 p2 p3 up to pn tar logot x jup kori dile hobo ki bhag ek to hodai ek thakiye jabo p1 e horon korile p2 e horon korile pn e horon korile ek baki thaki jabo tar mane ei notun number tu agor kita moulik sankhare bibhajjo no hoy so itself it's a new prime or at least it must contribute a new prime factor okay etu ta bhal argument boli mane
ami sir okhomiat khoba lage
ah etu hoy moi kele pura ke okhomiat kua nai karon olaman moi nam gitar pa dekhisu je olaman mixed audience u ase he karone kintu pasot moi basically ar okhomiate kom kintu buji na pale mu maje maje এনেকে কই দিলে বেছি ভাল যে এইটো ষ্টেটমেণ্ট বুজি পোৱা নাই ভালে কৰিছা তুমি কৈ দিছা গতিকে মই এইটো কৈছো যে 2 3 আৰু 5 যদি দিয়া আছে 2 3 গুণ 6 5 গুণ 30 তাৰ লগত এক যোগ দি দিয়া তেতিয়া হয় যেটো 31 পোৱা যাব হয় এটো এটা মৌলিক সংখ্যা হ'ব নলেবা ইয়াৰ ফেক্টৰ এটা মৌলিক সংখ্যা হ'ব ইয়াৰ এটা উৎপাদককে এটা নতুন মৌলিক সংখ্যা দিব তার পাছত সো প্রাইমস ইন এরিথমেটিক প্রোগ্রেশন দ্য এরিথমেটিক প্রোগ্রেশন হোয়াট ইজ এন এরিথমেটিক প্রোগ্রেশন মানে ইন কোয়া দা সিকোয়েন্স অফ নাম্বারস জিটু ইয়াত পাঁচ পাঁচ কে বাড়ি গৈছে সো ইচ টার্ম ইজ ফাইভ মোর দ্যান দ্য প্রিভিয়াস টার্ম সো দিস টাইপ অফ সিকোয়েন্স ইজ নোন এজ এরিথমেটিক প্রোগ্রেশন ওকে এন্ড দিস রেড কালার্ড নাম্বারস দে আর প্রাইম নাম্বারস সো So you can yourself frame a question. Eta prashna monole ahibo pare je inukua krom eta likhi gole yat kiman moulik sankha puwa jabo okim hoykok puwa jabone puwa jabo jen lagise kintu tar proman ki hobo in other words and Dirichlet was a big mathematician who proved this that you take any arithmetic progression the above was just an example 4, 9, 14, 19, that was just an example. You take any A and any common difference D and you take A, A plus D, A plus 2D, then you will always find infinitely many primes, but you need a condition that A and D should be co-prime. In other words, A and D should not have any common factor other than 1. ইয়াতে এতিয়া এই ক্ৰমটো কি হৈছে 4 9 14 19 আৰম্ভ হৈছে 4 আৰু 5 5কে বাঢ়িছে 4 আৰু 5 দুটা পৰস্পৰ মৌলিক সংখ্যা কেনেকুৱা যদি হয় তেতিয়ালে অসীম সংখ্যক মৌলিক সংখ্যা পোৱা যাব সো উইল অলৱেজ ফাইণ্ড ইনফাইনাইটলি মেনি প্ৰাইমছ সো ৰাফলি স্পিকিং ইটছ এ ভেৰি ৰাফ এজ আই ছেড ৰাফলি স্পিকিং দেট ইজ ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট বিকজ It, but it is I feel that it is important to know the essence of the proof because the whole proof will involve more technicalities and all but I just want to give you the essence of the proof and the essence is that you take sum of the reciprocals of all the primes appearing in such a progression I'm explaining it through the example so why I have taken 1 by 19 because this 19 was this term and this why I take okay sorry okay and this 19 okay there is a way to I guess cursor okay this 19 is coming from this 19 and this 29 it is coming from this so I take some of these reciprocals and then I compare it with sum of all primes reciprocals of all primes reciprocal mane 1 by that number okay multiply mane one by 2 1 by 3 1 by 5 if I add then I'll get a sum and what Dirichlet's argument is that this t and s if I divide t by s then it is not zero it is some finite number mane a particular case to in this particular case t is 1/4 of s but s is infinite so t has to be infinite And if a sum is infinite, then number of terms will be infinite because each term is finite. So if I am summing, if I am taking sum of finite numbers, but I am getting an infinite result, that means number of terms have to be, that number has to be infinite. Okay. Or other, so I'll say it in Assamese as well, that yat ki kora hoise, the jigita moulik sankha ei krom tu ahise, tahato reciprocal tu lua hoise, reciprocal tu loi jut kori diya hoise, hetu hoise t. Aru baki sokolu moulik sankhar ei reciprocal tu loi jut kora hoise. Aru ei sokolu primer lole etu অসীম হয় সেইটো প্ৰমাণ কৰিবলৈ সহজ. ফৰ এক্সাম্পল কেনে এইটো প্ৰুভ কৰিব পাৰি, গতিকে সেই প্ৰুভটোলৈ মই এতিয়া যোৱা নাই বাৰু, কিন্তু এই এছৰ কাৰণে এইটো কৰাটো সহজ যে এছটো ইনফাইনাইট, কিন্তু টি আৰু এছৰ যেতিয়া ৰেচিঅ'টো 1/4 তেতিয়াহ'লে টিটো ইনফাইনাইট, তাৰমানে নাম্বাৰ অফ টাৰ্মছ ইন টি ইজ ইনফাইনাইট. অ'কে, কিন্তু এইটো অলপ উই হেভ টু ডু ইট মোৰ প্ৰিচাইজলি এণ্ড উই শ্বুড বি এবল টু ডু ইট ফৰ এনি এৰিথমেটিক প্ৰগ্ৰেশ্যন, বাট দিছ ইজ দ্য এচেনচিয়েলি দ্য আইডিয়া. Of course, one has to take limit and all, etc., which I am not getting into details. Okay, so this is one question which could be answered, but there is another question which people have not been able to answer. So that is Goldbach conjecture. And conjecture, what is conjecture? It's a mathematical statement which is expected to be true, but there has not been any mathematical proof of it. No proof has been found yet. That word yet is important. It's likely that someone will prove it, and there are like billions of examples to support it. Numerical evidence is there that this statement is true. Hello? So that's what we have to, okay, I'll state this. Okay, so maybe as I see it, this might be an older version of the slides, but doesn't matter, because what you see here is that every even number is sum of two primes. Every even number bigger than 4 is sum of two primes. Okay, this is the question, or this is the observation Goldbach made. He wrote a letter to Euler. Euler was one of the most important mathematicians of all time. So he asked him, is every natural number bigger than 2 sum of two primes always? Hello. Okay, so Goldbach conjecture to enuka kotha je jikonu eta jugmo sankha sarike dangor sari ba sarike dangor duta moulik sankhar jugfol ei boli Goldbach e he conjectured, মানে তেওঁ এইটো statement ৰাখিলে, কিন্তু সেইটো প্ৰমাণ এতিয়ালৈকে হোৱা নাই। কিমান বছৰ আগতে এইটো কৰা হৈছে, 1742, তাতে অনুমান কৰিব পাৰি। এই প্ৰশ্নটো দেখাত বহুত সহজ, যিকোনো এটা নাম্বাৰ লৈ ল'লে 100টো কি বোলে 97+3 দুইটা প্ৰাইম নাম্বাৰ, তেনেকে যিকোনো নাম্বাৰ ল'লেই, মানে যিকোনো ইভেন নাম্বাৰ ল'লে, এক্সাম্পল ল'লে এইটো আমি দেখা পাম, কিন্তু সেইটোৱে এটা প্ৰমাণ নহয়। কাৰণ এক্সাম্পলে, আমি জানো যে এক্সাম্পলৰ উদাহৰণেৰে আমি প্ৰমাণ দিব নোৱাৰোঁ, কাৰণ এটা ব্যতিক্ৰমেই এটা মানে ষ্টেটমেণ্ট ভুল বুলি প্ৰমাণ কৰিব পাৰে। কাৰণ মেথমেটিক্সত এইটো বহুত ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট, 1 বিলিয়নটা এক্সাম্পলৰ ক্ষেত্ৰত যদি খাটিলেও এটাৰ ক্ষেত্ৰতো যদি ভুল হয় এটা, তেতিয়াহ'লে সেইটো ষ্টেটমেণ্টটো ভুল। এনেকুৱা ক্ষেত্ৰত কি কৰে, that this Goldbach conjecture was people still had difficulty, but they formed a related question, asked a related question, which is weak Goldbach conjecture. Weak Goldbach conjecture to key that every odd natural number bigger than 5 can be written as sum of 3 primes. Example, mane 7 to 3 jug 2 jug 2 21 11+7+3 যিকোনো এটা অড নাম্বাৰ, তিনিটা মৌলিক সংখ্যাৰ যোগফল দেখাত সমান টান যেনে লাগিছে দুইটা প্ৰব্লেম বাৰু, কিন্তু অৰিজিনেলটো বেছি টান, কাৰণ অৰিজিনেলটোৱে এইটো ইমপ্লাই কৰে, কেনেকে How does the original one imply this one? Because if we take an odd number bigger than 5, then we subtract 3 from it. Can duta odd number or difference to the even number? The n minus 3 to the even number. And this even number is sum of 2 primes by the strong conjecture, the Goldbach original conjecture. Then n will be 3 plus p plus q. That means to all, the strong conjecture to true hoy, weak to true hobo. But actually, dekhat similar statement holeo, weak Goldbach conjecture to any weak bully koa hoa nai, it all one weak hoy. Aru bhal kotha hetu je ek weak Goldbach conjecture to praman kora hoy goise. Aru yat dujon mathematician or basic significant contribution ase Vinogradov aru Helfgott. Kintu tar agote kobo lagibo je Hardy, ami Hardy hokole janu je Ramanujan ne jikon chiti likisile Cambridge jan professor le Trinity College asile teo he komor ejon dangor mathematician Hardy aru ke Hardy aru Littlewood. Hardy or Littlewood are both collaboration as well. Hardy or Littlewood weak Goldbach conjecture praman korisile kintu eta assumption dhori etu koy generalized Riemann hypothesis. Riemann hypothesis or bikoye moi pasot koi asu gotike kintu Riemann hypothesis tu dhori lole etu praman hoi goisile Hardy or Littlewood or darai dangor odd number or karone kintu সেই কন্ডিশনটো অতৰাই দিলে ভিনোগ্রাডোভে কি কৰিলে যে ৰিমান হাইপোথেসিসৰ দৰকাৰ নাই ৰিমান হাইপোথেসিস নহুৱাকেও হেতু ষ্টেটমেন্ট হ'ব গতিকে হেতু এটা ডাঙৰ ষ্টেপ যে এটা হাইপোথেসিস লৈ কৰা কিন্তু হে হাইপোথেসিসটো ভুল নে শুদ্ধ আমি নাজানো মানে ভুল মানে শুদ্ধ হ'লে হেতু হসা হয় মানে প্ৰুভে কৰিব পৰা নাই তেওঁলোকে কিন্তু গতিকে এটা কনজেকচাৰ লৈ পেলাই এটা কনজেকচাৰ প্ৰুভ কৰাৰ নিচিনা হৈছিল কিন্তু ভিনোগ্রাডোভে হেতু আতৰালে ডাঙৰ প্ৰাইম নম্বৰ ডাঙৰ অড নম্বৰৰ কাৰণে এণ্ড হেল্পগট বাকীখিনি কমপ্লিট কৰিলে গতিকে চ' হোৱাট আই এম ছেইং ইন আসামিজ ইজ দেট দিছ উইক কল বেক কনজেকচাৰ দেৰ ৱাজ এন আৰ্লিয়াৰ ছিগনিফিকেণ্ট কণ্ট্ৰিবিউচন বাই Hardy এণ্ড Littlewood বাট দে এজিউম আনাডাৰ কনজেকচাৰ হুইচ ইজ জেনেৰেলাইজ Riemann hypothesis অ'কে এণ্ড উইথ দেট দে proved the weak Goldbach conjecture for large odd numbers. And that dependence on that Riemann hypothesis was removed by Vinogradov. But still, that was true only for sufficiently large odd numbers. What do I mean by that? That means if the odd numbers are bigger than, I think, 3 to the power 3 to the power 15, then weak Goldbach conjecture is true. But that leaves out still lots of smaller odd numbers for which it needs to be verified. And everything is now done. So, although, I mean, the work is yet to be published, but it is in the process of being published. Aru eta conjecture ase bahut famous. Asolte bahut schooliya lora choliye sake jane twin prime conjecture boli. So what is twin prime conjecture? That p aru p plus 2 duitai jodi moulik sankha hoy তেতিয়ালে তাহাঁতক তাহাঁতক কোৱা হয় টুইন প্ৰাইম বুলি যেনে 3 and 5, 5 and 7, 11 and 13 দে আৰ লাইক এক্সাম্পলছ অফ টুইন প্ৰাইমছ বিকজ দে ডিফাৰ বাই 2 দ্য কুৱেশ্যন ইজ অবভিয়াছলি ৱেডাৰ দেৰ আৰ ইনফাইনাইটলি মেনি ছাচ পেয়াৰ্ছ দেট ইজ নোন এজ টুইন প্ৰাইম কনজেকচাৰ দেট দেৰ আৰ ইনফাইনাইটলি মেনি ছাচ প্ৰাইমছ অ'কে So it's an innocent looking statement, so to speak, but it's very difficult to people have not answered it fully. And in mathematics, there's another way to do things that you always generalize. What is so special about 2? It is just an odd number. It's just an even number. So rather than 2, not just 2, for any even number, it should work. For example, ami jodi 10 loi lo. It is 3 and 13, they differ by 10, 7 and 17, 13 and 23. These are both are prime numbers, they differ by 10. So this generalized conjecture says that there should be such pairs for any even number. Why even number? Because odd number certainly we cannot take, because you know that most primes are odd, except 2, all primes are odd. So 2 primes will always differ by an even number. So this generalized conjecture is that. And recently what happened that there has been some big progress on this conjecture. And what is that progress? That we do not know whether there will be infinitely many primes at gap of two, because this is like gap of two. Twin prime means gap of two. There are infinitely many primes. But the progress is that at least there is some finite number B such that there are infinitely many pairs of primes whose difference is less than B. And this was done by first Yitang Zhang for B, which is like 70 million, which is very big. And then later on, Maynard, Terence Tao, and many others, they brought it down to 246. Okay. Tar mane tu hol, duir gapot infinitely many primes ase na ami najanu, kintu etu kobo paru je hodai ami infinitely many pairs from P and Q, jar difference tu 246 otke holu. 246 ba tatke holu. Actually, at less than equal to dile beshi bhal asile. Jiki no, মানে এটো বি এটো আমি দুইৰ কাৰণে কৰিব লাগিব যেটো 246 ৰ কাৰণে কৰা হৈছে দুইৰ কাৰণে কৰিব লাগিব আৰু অৰিজিনেলি এটো 70 মিলিয়নৰ কাৰণে কৰা হৈছিল গতিকে তাৰ পৰা অনুমান কৰিব পাৰি এটা সমস্যাবোৰ কেনেকৈ হয় গণিত আৰু কেতামান মই সমস্যাৰ কথা কৈ দিছো দেখাত সহজ কিন্তু কৰিবলৈ বহুত টান যেনে n স্কোৱাৰ প্লাছ 1 ফৰ্মত অসীম সংখ্যক মৌলিক সংখ্যা আছে নেকি Are there infinitely many primes of the form n square plus 1? Then n to jodi ami 4 lo long 4 square plus 1 eto ta prime aru kinuka ase tenuka infinite ase neki tenuka question tol hetu 6 square plus 1 to eta prime tik tenai kinu question tol eta 8 square plus 1 to prime no hon question to are there infinitely many such primes So similarly, this is another open question. Is every even number can be realized as difference of two primes? For example, 2, we can write it as 5 minus 3, 4 is 11 minus 7, like that. So is this true for every even number? And another question, whether there is always a prime number between consecutive squares, n square and n plus 1 whole square? Then again, 3 square or 4 square mazot ami pam 11 13 4 square or 5 square mazot pam 19 and 5 square 6 square mazot pam 29 so can we always find a prime between two consecutive squares or this question are there infinitely many primes in this fibonacci sequence okay so similarly this there are many such questions or are there infinitely many sophie-germain primes What are Sophie-Germain primes? That P and 2P plus 1, both are prime. Then again, 3 and 7. 2 and 7 is 6. 5 and 11 is 2 and 2 is 11. Then you have pairs who infinitely many are. Then you have both donor prosna koriva pari prime number of glory. Zivila prosna to korato hos, kintu uttor dia to tan. Kothin. Aru prime, itia aru mulgut kor duta ne tinda slide ase. তাৰপিছত আমি ডিছকাশ্যনলৈ যাম চ' মানে আমি ভাবিব পাৰোঁ হাউ প্ৰাইম নাম্বাৰ্ছ আৰ ইউজফুল যে ইমানখিনি প্ৰাইমক লৈ আমি এই কুৱেশ্যন কৰিলোঁ বেছিভাগে অলপ থিয়ৰিটিকেল কুৱেশ্যনৰ নিচিনা বা অলপ কিউৰিয়চিটিৰ নিচিনা যে এইটো হয়নে এইটো নহয়নে তেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ প্ৰশ্ন কিন্তু তাৰ কিবা ডে টু ডে লাইফত তাৰ কিবা প্ৰয়োগ হয় নেকি হোৱাট ইজ দ্য ইউজ অফ প্ৰাইমছ অ'কে তাৰে চ' ওৱান এপ্লিকেশ্যন ইজ ইন ক্ৰিপ্ট'গ্ৰাফি ক্ৰিপ্ট'গ্ৰাফি মানে এনেকুৱাকে ক'ব পাৰি যে গুপ্ত ধৰণে মেছেজ যিটো দিয়া মানে যাতে বেলেগে গম নাপায় চ' ইন ক্ৰিপ্ট'গ্ৰাফি মেছেজেছ আৰ এনক্ৰিপ্টেড বিফ'ৰ কমিউনিকেশ্যন চ' ডেট অনলি দ্য ইণ্টেণ্ডেড ৰিচিভাৰ কেন ডেচিফাৰ ইট যেনেকৈ আমাৰ হোৱাটছআপ মেছেজবিলাক আমি হোৱাটছআপ কৰি দিলোঁ কিন্তু মেছেজটো ক'ড হৈ পেলাই যায় অ'কে চ' লাইক আৱাৰ হোৱাটছআপ মেছেজেছ They do not go simply as words. They are converted to something else. They are converted to numbers. Then the numbers get transmitted. Then again, it is from numbers, again, words come back. And then those messages we see. So that no one else can I mean, this privacy is not destroyed. Okay, so that we can, only the intended receiver can see our messages, or like our all these passwords, etc. So they are all encrypted, meaning they are coded. And how this coding is done? This coding is done sometimes using RSA crypto system, because nowadays there are some other ways also to do it. But RSA crypto system is still largely in use. It is named after these inventors, Rivest, Shamir, and Edelman. And RSA crypto system, or what is the working principle? That it is extremely time consuming to factorize the product of two large primes. Tar mane to hol je a RSA crypto system to security to kopa hai je jodi duta bahut dangor prime loi lua jay aur tahator puron koi dia jay he puron fold tur ako factorize kobole bahut tan ami jodi okol puron fold tu kabak di diu ami schoolot eta eneke go paru je thik ase amak jete ba kete ba utpadokot bhangi bole die jodi amak সৰু সৰু নাম্বাৰ দিয়ে বা দুই আৰু তিনিৰ সংযোৱা নাম্বাৰ দিলে আমি ইজিলি কৰিব পাৰোঁ এটা প্ৰাইম ডাঙৰ হ'লেও যদি এটা সৰু হয় ইজি হৈ যায় বোলে 3×97 আমাক যদি প্ৰডাক্টটো দি দিলে আমি ইজিলি ফেক্টৰাইজ কৰিব পাৰোঁ কিন্তু যদি আমাক 41×47 দি দিয়ে আমাক টাইম লাগিব আমি 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 19, 17, 19 গোটেই বহুত চাব লাগিব তাৰপাছত 41 পামগৈ চ' দেট উইল দেট প্ৰচেছ উইল টেক টাইম That if we are asked to factorize 3×97, of course, without being told that 3 and 97 are the factors. So if we are given the product of 3 and 97, we can easily factorize it. But if we are given the product of 41 and 47, it'll take more time, because when we are looking for factors, we'll have to go by primes. Like we'll go for 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17. It'll take time to go to reach up to 41. Then imagine this difficulty when these primes have like 200 digits, because they are large primes. If we take two large primes and take their product and give it open to everyone, still considerable time will be needed. And without that factorization, this this encryption cannot be broken. So that is where the security is coming from, large primes. Okay, that is one use of large primes. Okay, so coding enoka cryptography koribole hole tuta dangor dangor prime hankha loile bahut dangor bole 200 ta tat sankha ase 200 ta eta prime 200 ta sankha ase aru itu prime 200 ta sankha ase ta so tar product tu didile etu factorize koribole bosor lagi jabo aru bosor pasot kunuba amar message tu salu tar iban eta মানে প্ৰেক্টিকেল ইউজ নাথাকিব আৰু সেইটো গম পালেও ইমান দেৰিকৈ গম পালে লাভ নহ'ব কাৰণ যিটো পাৰ্পাছত ভাঙিবলৈ চাই ইয়াৰ মেছেজবিলাক বোলে বেংক পাছৱৰ্ড বা বেলেগ কিবা এটা চ' ইটছ লাইক দেট অ'কে অ'কে চ' দিছ ইজ চামথিং অ'কে চ' এজ আই ছেড দিছ ইজ একচুৱেলি দ্য প্ৰিভিয়াছ ভাৰ্চন অফ দ্য শ্লাইডছ বিকজ আই হেড টু ৰিমুভ মাই ৰেকৰ্ডেড ভিডিঅ' এণ্ড অডিঅ' অ'কে এনিৱে So then where do we find the large primes? Maybe I will not elaborate too much on this. That there is a theorem called prime number theorem, which actually tells us that the nth prime is like n log m. And this is the statement of prime number theorem, that pi n behaves like n by log n when n is very large. What is pi n? Pi n is the number of primes up to n. For example, if I take 4, what is pi 4? It is 2, because I have 2 primes up to 4. It is 2 and 3. What is pi of 10? It is 2, 3, 5, 7. So pi of 10 is 4. So what this statement is saying, that suppose n is a very large number, let's say 1 billion. Then how many prime numbers are there up to 1 billion? It is 1 billion by log of 1 billion. Roughly, I mean, because this means it's not like exact equal, but this behavior will be very close. If we take an n billion, if I take 100 billion, this is even better. Okay, so it's like that. In that sense, it's known as asymptotic behavior. And why am I mentioning it? it is not just an important theorem, but it is for this purpose that nth prime number is like n log n. Okay. So in other words, যদি আমি বহুত এন টো বহুত ডাঙৰ নাম্বাৰ লৈ লওঁ যে ওৱান বিলিয়ন বোলে ওৱান বিলিয়ন নাম্বাৰ প্ৰাইমটো কিমান চাইজৰ হ'বনো সেইটো ওৱান বিলিয়ন টাইমছ লগ অফ ওৱান বিলিয়ন অ'কে ইয়াৰ বেছটো ডাঙৰ কথা নহয় বাৰু কি বেছ লৈছোঁ কাৰণ ইট ইজ জাষ্ট এটা অৰ্ডাৰ বুজাইছে কিমান কিমান ধৰণৰ হ'ব আৰু প্ৰাইম নাম্বাৰ থিয়ৰামটো এটা আৰু কিছুমান ইণ্টাৰেষ্টিং মানে কনচিকুৱেঞ্চ আছে যে প্ৰবেবিলিটি কিনো আমি যদি এটা নাম্বাৰ ল'লোঁ সেইটো প্ৰাইম হ'বনে কম্প'জিট হ'ব তাৰ কি প্ৰবেবিলিটি এইটো হৈছে ওৱান বাই লগ এন যদি আমি ডাঙৰ এটা নাম্বাৰ লওঁ সেইটো মৌলিক সংখ্যা নে যৌগিক সংখ্যা সেইটো প্ৰবেবিলিটি হ'ব ওৱান বাই লগ এন তাৰ মানেটো হ'ব যদি আমি যিমানে ডাঙৰ সংখ্যা লওঁ প্ৰাইম হোৱাৰ প্ৰবেবিলিটিটো আধা হৈ যাব তাৰ মানেটো এইটো যদি আমি টু এন ডিজিট থকা এটা নাম্বাৰ লওঁ তাৰ প্ৰাইম হোৱাৰ প্ৰবেবিলিটি এন ডিজিট থকা নাম্বাৰ এটাতকৈ আধা হৈ যাব অৰ্থাৎ যদি এটা নাম্বাৰত বোলে এশটা ডিজিট আছে সি প্ৰাইম হোৱাৰ যিমান সম্ভাৱনা আছে দহ হাজাৰটা ডিজিট থকা নাম্বাৰটোৰ প্ৰাইম হোৱাৰ প্ৰবেবিলিটি আধা এইটো এই লগাৰিথমিক বিহেভিয়াৰটোৰ কাৰণে আহিছে কাৰণ আমি জানো যে লগ অফ থাউজেণ্ড আই মিন হাণ্ড্ৰেড স্কুৱাৰ ইজ টু টাইমছ লগ অফ হাণ্ড্ৰেড অৰ্থাৎ ডিজিট ডাবল কৰি দিলে প্ৰবেবিলিটি হাফ হৈ যাব এইটো যিসকল তোমালোকৰ যিসকলে লগাৰিথম পাইছা So those of you who are familiar with log, you'll recognize that log of 100 square is 2 times log of 100. That means to all, if some number has 100 square digits, the probability of becoming prime is almost half of the probability of a 100 number digit being prime. Okay. So, and my finally, I come to the last slide. of my recorded talk that is the zeta function and Riemann hypothesis okay so what is why am I mentioning it in this context and to be honest I wanted to mention it is because it is a very famous unsolved problem this probably most famous unsolved problem now in mathematics there was one called Fermat's last theorem which was unsolved for 350 years but Andrew Weil solved it and now this is one of the most famous problems left but I brought it into the context that it also tells us something about prime number theorem the error term because pi n behaves like n by log n but it is not that exactly they are same there is some error term their difference is not zero their difference is something which can be approximated if we know the Riemann hypothesis So that is the way I am motivating it here, but there are a lot of other motivations because Riemann hypothesis or its analog is there everywhere in mathematics. Okay, and this is my final slide, and to state the hypothesis, I need to define what is the zeta function. So the Riemann zeta function, it is sum of the reciprocals of powers of natural numbers. So zeta s. to ki hoy je 1 plus 1 by 2 to the power s plus 1 by 3 to the power s you take this infinite sum what is s normally ami s to natural number lobo paru kintu etia iyate complex number lua hoyse just tumalok mane ara abak dibo khujisu karon gute details tu kua iyate hombob no hobo just eta abak kinu Riemann zeta function etu eta ei s to iyate complex number so etu eta infinite series aru এইটোক এই ধৰণেও লিখিব পাৰি যে ওৱান মাইনাছ ওৱান বাই টু এছ ওৱান মাইনাছ ওৱান বাই থ্ৰী এছ ওৱান মাইনাছ ওৱান বাই ফাইভ এছ এই টু থ্ৰী ফাইভ দিজ আৰ প্ৰাইম নাম্বাৰ্ছ ৱাই আই কেন ৰাইট ইট লাইক দিছ বিকজ ইফ ইউ থিংক অফ দিছ এজ এন এৰিথমেটিক চৰি জিঅ'মেট্ৰিক প্ৰগ্ৰেশ্যন ইট ইজ একচুৱেলি লাইক ইট ইজ লাইক টু টু দি ওৱান প্লাছ টু টু দি পাৱাৰ মাইনাছ এছ প্লাছ টু টু দি পাৱাৰ মাইনাছ টু এছ লাইক দেট ইট ইজ ওৱান প্লাছ থ্ৰী টু দি পাৱাৰ মাইনাছ এছ plus 3 to the power minus 2s it's like 1 by 1 minus r is the sum of 1 plus r square like that so it is essentially coming from that geometric series okay and these two are equal only when real part of S is bigger than one. That is needed for convergence. Because you know that when you have an infinite sum, it may be finite or the sum might be infinite. For example, if I take S to be 1, it is infinite. Because 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4, it is infinite. Why it is so? One beautiful argument is you take 1, then 1 by 2. Next, two terms you combine, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. This is bigger than 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. So it is bigger than half. Next, you take next four terms, that will be bigger than half. So you'll get arbitrarily many 1 by 2 in this sum. This sum will be bigger than arbitrarily many halves. So it is infinite. Okay. And you don't have to follow everything that I'm saying. I mean, depending if you're like a school student and all. But this is just for you to think about these things. It's not expected that you'll understand the whole thing or that I am stating everything, but it is just to give you an overview or some thing to think about or what lies ahead, so to speak. And so my final two lines, this penultimate line is that the zeta function can be extended for the real part of S less than equal to 1 also by analytic continuation. You need not understand this term fully, and it is not even exactly correct mathematically. It is known as meromorphic continuation. But anyway, I do not want to go into those details. You just need to know that this function, it was earlier defined on one half of the complex plane, but it is defined on the other half also. And what is Riemann hypothesis? I'll conclude with this, that all the zeros of the extended zeta function lies on the line real part of S equal to half. In other words, in simple terms, if sigma of zeta of sigma plus square root of minus 1 t is 0, then sigma must be half. So it's a big statement. Okay. Those of you who are familiar with complex numbers, you know that this is square root of minus 1, we denote it by I. So we are saying that if we have a 0 of the Riemann zeta function, its real part must be half. Of course, there are this notion of non-trivial zeros, trivial zeros. So my intention is not to give all those technical things. So I'm just roughly speaking, this is what is Riemann hypothesis. Why it is a $1 million question? Literally, it is a $1 million question because there's a $1 million price tag. If someone does it, he'll win $1 million. And it is one of the 7 millennium problems. What are millennium problems? That 7 problems were identified in the year 2000. মানে 2000 চনত 7টা প্ৰবলেম গণিতৰ কাৰণে ডাঙৰ প্ৰবলেম চিহ্নিত কৰা হৈছে। তাৰ ভিতৰত আছে Riemann hypothesis এটা। যে এইটো এটা ইমানে এটা ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট প্ৰবলেম, এটো এটা মাইলেনিয়াম প্ৰবলেম। আৰু অফ কোর্স এটো কোনোবাই কৰিব পাৰিলে ম্যাথমেটিকেলি হি উইল বি ইমমৰ্টেল। বিকজ ইট ইজ সাচ এ ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট কোৱেশ্চন। সো মানে মই ইমানতে কৈ মোৰ ফালৰ পৰা কবলগাখিনি সামৰিছো। আৰু এতিয়া তোমালোকে কিবা যদি সুধিব লগা আছে বা কিবা কথা আছে দেন ইউ ক্যান আস্ক। সো এন্ড ইউ ফিল ফ্রি টু আস্ক ইন আসামিজ এন্ড ইন ইংলিশ অর ওকে সো দ্যাট উই ক্যান হ্যাভ দা ডিসকাশন।
ধন্যবাদ ডক্টর অনুপম পাইকিয়া, দিস ইজ নীল কমল, ফর দিস বিউটিফুল লেকচার এন্ড এনলাইটিং আওয়ার স্টুডেন্টস এন্ড এনকারেজিং দ্য স্টুডেন্টস। মই প্ৰথমতে জুমৰ কোৱেশ্যনৰ পৰা আৰম্ভ কৰিছোঁ, বাকী প্লেটফৰ্মত থকা কোৱেশ্যনখিনিও আমি সামৰিম। প্ৰথম কোৱেশ্যনটো সুধিছে সায়ন নন্দীয়ে, ছাৰ আই হেভ এ কোৱেশ্যন, হাউ টু চেক এ বিগ নাম্বাৰ লাইক 5897 অৰ 6113 এটচেট্ৰা, ৱেডাৰ ইট ইজ প্ৰাইম অৰ কম্পজিট।
অকে, সো অফ কোর্স দ্য ক্লাসিক্যাল ওয়ে ইজ টু চেক প্রাইম বাই প্রাইম, লাইক দি সিভ মেথড, ইউ ট্রাই বাই 2 3 5 7 এটসেট্রা। But there's also an algorithm, AKS, this primality testing, the algorithm is there now. So but these numbers are too small, so that can be handled by checking manually. Because you just have to check up the square root of that number. You suppose it is say 4135 or whatever number, then you have to check whether it is divisible by primes up to square root of 4135. তো প্ৰশ্নটো হ'ল এনেকুৱা যে এটা প্ৰাইম নাম্বাৰ দিলে আমি এটা নাম্বাৰ দিলে আমি প্ৰাইম হয়নে নহয় কেনেকৈ চেক কৰিম। আমি এটা ধৰণে জানো যে আমি প্ৰাইম ফেক্টৰ কিটা এদি সাব লাগিব দু আমাৰ কি সালনি প্ৰণালী বুলি কোৱা হৈছিল বুট কৰো দেট 2, 3, 5, 7 এফালৰ পৰা চাই যাম আৰু আমি সাব লাগিব যদি নাম্বাৰটো 100 হয় তেতিয়া আমি স্কোয়াৰ্ড অফ 100 ৰ তলৰ প্ৰাইম এদি চালে হ'ব মানে যদি নাম্বাৰটো 100 হয় আমি 7 লৈকে চালে হ'ব কাৰণ 11, 11, 121 হৈ যাব 100তকৈ ডাঙৰ হৈ যাব গতিকে আমি তেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ কথা সো Yeah, but otherwise there's an algorithm called AKS algorithm. Okay. Any other any quick?
Yeah. Thank you. Then I think Sayan Nandiye Bujipala. Next question to Khudisa Devi Shandai. Sir, are conjectures same as axioms and postulates?
It is a bit, yeah, it's a very good question. So conjectures are something that it's in a way it is different from axioms because it's like it is I mean axioms we assume to establish a theory and within that theory we have certain statements which should be true which we expect to be true because there is numerical evidence maybe or there is other kind of evidence so but mostly number theory it is like numerical evidence So the this is expected to be true. So this is like a conjecture, okay? And assuming that conjecture, if you prove something else, so that becomes that conjecture. The first conjecture is becomes like a hypothesis for the second one, second proof. But yeah, so that way. I mean, for example, axioms like okay, the parallel lines never intersect. Okay, so that's like an axiom. But Goldbach conjecture. Why we call it conjecture? Because I mean we expect it to be true. We see it through examples, but yeah, we have not proved it yet.
Okay. Thank you. Anupam da, apni slide to stop share koriba pare.
Oh, acha. Sorry. Yes.
That may be better.
Okay. Just a moment. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. তাৰ পিছৰ প্ৰশ্নটো সুধিছে থেংক ইউ দেৱী চেন্দা ফৰ আস্কিং দ্য নাইচ কুৱেশ্যন তাৰ পিছতো আহিছে প্ৰত্যাশাৰ পৰা যে 23 মৌলিক সংখ্যা কিন্তু 23 + 10 = 33 মৌলিক নহয়
আচ্ছা মই মই এইটো বুজি পাইছো কেলৈ সুধিছে কাৰণ মই কৈছিলো যে 10ৰ গেপত ইনফাইনাইটলি মেনি প্ৰাইম নাম্বাৰ আছে কিন্তু এইটো নুবুজাই যে প্ৰতিটো মৌলিক সংখ্যাৰ কাৰণেই এইটো শুদ্ধ হ'ব এইটোৱে বুজাইছে যে 23 + 10 হ'লে 33 সেই পেয়াৰটো নহয় কিন্তু বোলে তেনেকুৱা নাম্বাৰ মানে টেনৰ গেপত মই কেইটামান দিছিলোঁ এক্সাম্পল 7 আৰু 17 হয় এতিয়া 17 আৰু 27টো নহয় কিন্তু 37 and 47 হয় গতিকে কোৱা হৈছে যে এইটো নহয় যে প্ৰতিটো মৌলিক সংখ্যাৰ লগত 10 যোগ কৰিলে এটা মৌলিক সংখ্যা পাম এইটো কোৱা হৈছে যে এটা মৌলিক সংখ্যাৰ লগত 10 যোগ কৰিলেও মৌলিক সংখ্যা পোৱাকে অসংখ্য মৌলিক সংখ্যা আছে যেনেকে 3, 7 তেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ নাম্বাৰবিলাক মানে 13, 31, 31 such primes which differ by 10.
Okay, thank you. তাৰ পিছৰ প্ৰশ্নটো সুধিছে দেৱাংগাই ইজ দিছ সেম এজ হ্যাশিং প্ৰসেস এটো কি কৈছে মই বুজি পোৱা নাই
অ' এটো মই নুকুৱাই ভাল হ'ব তেতিয়া হ'লে মই ধৰিব পৰা নাই ঠিক তেওঁ কি সুধিছে তেওঁ উৎকৰ্ল কোডিঙৰ কথা সুধিছে নেকি
দেৱাংগা তুমি আনমিউট কৰি ক'ব পাৰিবা নেকি কি প্ৰশ্ন সুধিছে এটো
দেৱাংগই এটা কথা মই সুধা দেখিছো যে কেন উই পুট ৰিলেশ্বনশিপ
সাৰে যেটো ক্ৰিপ্টোগ্ৰাফি কথাটো কৈছিলে সেইটো লগত মানে লিংক আছে
নাই মই যিটো বুজাব খুজিছো যে প্ৰাইম নাম্বাৰ ক্ৰিপ্টোগ্ৰাফিত কেনেকে প্ৰয়োগ হয় সেইটোহে মই ইয়াত ক'ব খুজিছো যে তাত এটা মডুলাৰ এৰিথমেটিক ইউজ হয় যিকোনো কেনেকৈ কৰা হয় প্ৰথমতে এটা যেনিবা ৱৰ্ড আছে সেই ৱৰ্ডটো আমি এটা নাম্বাৰলৈ কনভাৰ্ট কৰি ল'ব পাৰোঁ আৰু সেই নাম্বাৰটো আমি নপঠিয়াই পেলাই তাৰ এটা এক্সপ'নেণ্ট এটা পাৱাৰ এটা পঠিয়াই দিওঁ আৰু সেই পাৱাৰটো হৈছে মডুলো প্ৰডাক্ট অফ টু প্ৰাইমছ কেনেকুৱা প্ৰডাক্ট অফ টু লাৰ্জ প্ৰাইমছ আৰু সেই ফেক্টৰাইজেশ্যনটো জানিলে সেইটো ডিকোড কৰিব পাৰি তাৰ মানে ইনভাৰ্চটো ইজিলি উলিয়াব পাৰি ৰাফলি স্পিকিং কিন্তু এইটো নাম্বাৰ থিয়ৰী কিতাপত ভালকৈ পোৱা যাব Okay. Yeah.
Next question is by MS. Prime numbers have two factors, but one has only one factor. So is one a prime number or neither prime nor composite?
One is not a prime number or composite number. Because what is a prime number? It should have two factors. And composite number should have more than two factors. And actually, why we do not call it a prime number? There are other reasons also, then you can generalize. Because one has an inverse. Because this notion of prime number, it is also there for integers. Then one and minus one, we don't call them primes because they are invertible elements. One into one is one and minus one is one. So these type of numbers are not included in prime numbers. Okay. So yeah, so they basically the answer is no.
Okay, thank you. এটা ইউটিউবৰ পৰা কোৱেশ্যন আহিছে তমন্নাই আমালে ফৰৱাৰ্ড কৰিছে দিব্যজ্যোতি ডেকাই হাউ দা হেকাৰ্ছ ব্ৰক দা কোড এণ্ড হেক দা পাছৱৰ্ড
ওকে সো ইয়া দেৰ আৰ সাম ৱেজ টু ডু দেট আই ডোন্ট থিংক ইট উইল বি পসিবল টু এক্সপ্লেইন ইট হিয়াৰ বাট নট বাই ডাইৰেক্ট ফেক্টৰাইজেশ্যন দে ট্ৰাই আদাৰ ৱেজ ওকে বিকজ ট্ৰাইং ইট দা ফেক্টৰাইজেশ্যন ৱে ইজ ভেৰি টাইম কনজিউমিং সো ইয়া দেৰ আৰ ৱেজ টু ডু দেট
Yeah.
So I think you okay at this point of time maybe I should mention that this some like which this I'm recommending these books because they are easily available in India and Indian edition is also there like Elementary Number Theory by Barton I'm sure most of you have heard of it so yeah you can see that book
amar etu platform on zoomor platform ot Nikita Doctor khodise how many factors of prime numbers are there
maybe prime numbers because they have only two factors one and the prime number itself
okay so from Nabajit Ray we have another question can we define a metric function which can yield successive prime numbers
successive prime numbers metric function it's not clear to me what you mean by that of course you have the usual metric okay that in real numbers that you have that metric and yeah but if you are asking about the distribution of primes or the gap of primes of course there are a lot of things that are not known about primes on one hand they can differ by two on the other hand their gaps may be arbitrarily large okay what do I mean by that suppose I don't want 100 primes I want like some natural numbers consecutive natural numbers with no primes suppose I want 10 such composite numbers consecutively then I can get that I can get even 100 consecutive numbers consecutive composite numbers how do I get that using the factorial function for example let me give an example with like 10 consecutive numbers 10 consecutive composite numbers mane 10 ta jogik sankha ekeletrike thokage kenege pam je 10 factorial plus 2 10 factorial plus 3 10 factorial plus 4 up to 10 factorial plus 10 because if I take 10 factorial plus 2 hetu duire horon jabo it will be divisible by 2 10 factorial plus 3 it will be divisible by 3 and there will be some other factor also because it is not just 3 so that way we'll have 10 consecutive composite numbers and the 10 is just an arbitrary thing you can make it 1 million also so we can get 1 million consecutive composite numbers so the gap between primes you can make it arbitrarily large also on the other hand by twin prime conjecture you can actually make it 2 also so the primes are very randomly distributed
okay thank you Anupam da and Navajit Ray for asking the question eta facebook or pra ata question aise will the interval of two prime numbers will keep increasing in ascending order if yes
actually okay so I think I partly answered that it is no because twin primes will be there so this if I mean because twin prime conjecture anyway we expect it to be true so that shows that this gap can be two also, because there are infinitely many primes. So after some big gap, there might be again a small gap of two. And just before what I said, that there can be arbitrary gaps as large as we want. Like I can get 100 consecutive composite numbers. On one hand, I can get the gap as 1 million. At the same time, the gap will be 2 or at least 246, because that was this twin prime conjecture, although it is not proved. But we know that at the gap of 246, there are infinitely many primes. So that gap between primes, you can say that it is bounded above by 246.
One more question, YouTuber Dipjyoti Dekarpara. Sir, I have one more question. If someone will solve Riemann's zeta function, is it possible to tell how many prime numbers are there up to infinity?
Yeah, it helps in, yeah, because it has to do with prime number theorem. Because as I said, this prime number theorem, it counts the number of primes less than a number n. There's a function called pi n that I mentioned, that pi 10 is, for example, 4, because we have 2, 3, 5, 7, 4 primes up to 10. So pi 10 is 4. But this 10 is a very small number. What happens? N is very large. That if n is very large, pi n is behaves like n by log n. Okay. So, but there is a gap. So what is the difference between pi n and n by log n? And that difference is better understood if Riemann hypothesis is true. So if the Riemann hypothesis is true, then one can say that this pi n and difference between pi n and n by log n, it, one has a better understanding. And that way, Riemann hypothesis can say something about the distribution of primes. Like that.
Okay, there is another related question, I think, that has come from one of our members. What is the most important practical application of Riemann hypothesis, and what practical problems it is supposed to solve in future?
Okay, so practical purpose, I suppose. Okay, so I can say only as far as I know that of course there will be many other applications, and as I said, many analogs, and they are so useful, not just mathematically. I mean, they are of course mathematically of huge importance, but I would say that even if we understand the distribution of primes, then we'll be able to locate the prime numbers better if we know the Riemann hypothesis. That is my understanding, that if we know the Riemann hypothesis, we'll be able to know better about the distribution of primes, and that will help us to locate the primes. Okay, so I would say it like that, that way it helps. But of course, yeah, so I'm not, so I should not say that I am an expert on that. But yeah.
Okay, next person. Thank you, Anupamda. Navajit Barmane, probably related. What is Lindelof hypothesis?
So probably it will be too technical for me to say it here, actually. So I would say that you better to look at books. Okay, so yeah.
There is another question from Devanko. Can we put relation between prime numbers in golden ratio?
Not that I know, but there might be. Actually, I don't know. I should not. Not that I aware of, but there might be something.
Then there is another question from Navajit again. Is subconvexity problem and the Lindelof hypothesis are same? Probably you have already told that. It's
yeah. So no, I'll not comment on that. Actually, yeah.
Okay. Amar Majorpra Hiranyadai Khudise, what is the difference between a conjecture and a hypothesis?
Okay, so hypothesis is something that we assume when we go on to prove something. Okay, so in that sense, our whatever we prove is conditionally true, because we assume certain conditions so that our task becomes a bit easier, so to speak, or we can but what is a conjecture is like that, there is it is expected to be true, but when I assume something, maybe we are assuming something wrong also, but mathematically we'll reach at the right conclusion, although we don't know whether assumption is true or not. Okay, but conjecture is a statement that we expect it to be true, I mean, and there's numerical evidence for it. Okay, so that way I can put anything in the assumption. Okay, so I can for example, I can assume that 2 is less than 2 is less than 1, then I can, and that assumption may be wrong, but everything else I can work out perfectly, and that will be a mathematically correct proof, although the assumption is wrong. But yeah, but the conjecture is something that is expected to be true. It's just a matter of time in most cases. Of course, sometimes they turn out to be false also.
So 2 is less than 1 is a conjecture or a hypothesis?
No, I would say that it is not. But yeah, I mean, our assumption can be, sometimes we may assume something which,
thank you, Anupamda. Yeah, Prishar Prasno to Kudise, Abhinjan Saraswat Gogoye. Sir, I have a question. I took on Lamba. If P1, P2 and P3 are prime numbers, and A is equal to P1 into P2 into P3 plus 1, and B is equal to P1 into P2 into P3 minus 1. So are A and B prime numbers?
I guess one cannot answer it often. Sometimes it may be true, but certainly, so sometimes maybe it is true. It may appear to be true for some cases, but I cannot say that this will be always true. Yeah, so one has to work on that. But related to this, I will say one thing which I forgot to mention. Good that you mentioned that. Suppose you take product of, say, first 10 primes and 8 1, is it going to be a prime number or composite number? In other words, we discussed this how Euclid proved existence of infinitely many primes. Suppose you know p1 up to pn, then you take all their product and add 1. So you get what is known as Euclidean number. So this way you are getting the nth Euclidean number. For example, the first Euclidean number will be what? Okay, if you start with 2. Hello? So that question is whether there are infinitely many Euclidean numbers which are prime, or whether there are infinitely many Euclidean numbers which are composite, that also is not known. In this particular case, I don't know often, but maybe you'll be able to find some examples, and then it will be a question whether there will be infinitely many. Okay, so yeah, so one has to look at it more closely. Hello? Yeah, sorry.
Okay, so we have another question from Piyush. He asks, will the interval of 2 prime numbers will keep increasing in ascending order? If yes, what will be its pattern?
Okay, I'll answer that. But one thing that I want to say regarding the previous question, that if you notice P1, P2, P3 plus 1, then one of these has to be 2. Because otherwise, if you take 3 odd primes, then it will be odd, and plus 1, it will be even. So A will become an even number and B will become an even number, unless one of these 3 primes is 2. Okay, so certainly A and B should be odd, and that will require P1 to be 2. Okay, so now the question is, you can probably check 2 into 3 into 5. And 2 into 3 into 5 minus 1 and plus 1. In that case, it is satisfying like 31 and 29. Okay, but yeah, you have to keep 1 prime 2. That thing is visible from here. And yeah. So yeah. So there are, and the gap between the primes, as I said already, that this gap is not more than 246 in that sense. Like there might be large gaps of 1 million, but then again later again it will not be more than 246, because Terence Tao and Maynard and all, they showed that there are infinitely many primes which differ by at most 246. So that means we may get a gap of 1 billion. Then after that, we go further. Again, there will be at the gap of 246. There will be two primes. Okay, because there are infinitely many such primes. That means it is not bounded above. So you can always find that. And in fact, twin prime conjecture says that this is two, that this gap. In fact, you can always, after some point, again, you'll find two primes at the gap of two. Then again, maybe there'll be a gap of 1 billion also, possible. But again, there'll be a gap of two if twin prime conjecture is true. And even without going to conjecture, we can say that at least 246 we'll get.
Devanga is asking another question, but I think some words are missing. I couldn't understand it. Anything to the power of negative of a prime number. So I am
better. Anything to the power of negative.
Devanga, if you are there, then you can ask face to face what you want to ask. Tumi tomar tomar nijoke unmute kori khodibo para tumi jodi asa. Okay, we'll come to it next. Then we have another question from another member of our team. What exactly is meant by numerical evidence?
Okay, numerical evidence, I mean, for example, let's say Goldbach conjecture. Now, it is saying that every even number bigger than 2 is sum of 2 primes. Now, we can check, like we can check up to 1 million or we can check up to 1 billion and then convince ourselves that yes, for up to 1 billion, it is true. And since that means we are getting like 1 billion examples, or okay, half a billion, because half of them will be odd. But still, we are getting so many examples that it should be true. Okay, we mean it that way, that computers can verify for very, very large numbers. Okay, and in fact, I think it is Vinogradov who proved that Goldbach conjecture is true for most even numbers, meaning the number of even numbers for which Goldbach conjecture may fail has density zero. Density zero means there are very few. Still can be infinite, but that means very few. That very few even numbers will fail Goldbach conjecture, if at all. Okay. But yeah, numerical evidence means it is always, I mean, whatever even number we are taking, but then that way we can go up to maybe some billion, but there are so many, these are like so many bigger and bigger even numbers, and it's not bounded above. So yeah.
Okay, Anupam Da, one question from Facebook, Diganta Dasar Hudise. Sir, please tell about pyramidon formula.
Sorry?
Pyramidon formula.
I don't know that actually, what it means, or maybe I don't know the theorem itself, so I'll not be able to say.
Yeah, it's okay.
So we have another question here, Navazit Barman. Actually, it's not a question. So he is asking you to recommend a book for Lindelof hypothesis and subconvexity problem.
Okay, so maybe I'll post it, because right now I cannot say often. So yeah, what is will be suitable. What I suggested was a very basic book, but of course you'll not find these things there. That this is Barton's book. That is like probably the first book that in India that students get to see. Of course, there are some other books like Davenport's Higher Arithmetic, etc. They are very nicely written books, but Indian edition is not there, I think. So that is the problem. Otherwise, it's an expensive book. But Barton's book is.
So we move to the next question. Sayan Nandi is asking another question. Sir, I have if we have a prime number, then how can we estimate or compute the next prime number in a faster way?
That I will not be able to say. I can say only that prime number theorem helps to certain extent to locate it, but yeah, so that I don't really know, but yeah, from maybe like assuming Riemann hypothesis and this, and of course prime number theorem is known, so you may roughly able to place it, but yeah. Okay. Because pi and because of pi and asymptotic behavior is known, so that way it may help to some extent, but how practically it is done, that I don't know.
Okay, we have one more question from one of our team members. So he wants to know why prime are called prime numbers. Can negative numbers be prime numbers?
Okay, so why prime numbers are called prime numbers? I suppose prime basically may mean important probably, and these numbers are important because any natural number we can get as product of prime numbers. So I suppose that it is of primary importance, and maybe because of that this number, these numbers are called prime numbers. And yeah, like negative numbers also called prime numbers because when we generalize, because this is, we started with natural numbers, but then we go to integers. When we say integers, like we include 0 and minus 1, minus 2, etc. Then what are prime numbers? Then we have to also first say what are units. Units mean invertible elements, means who have multiplicative inverse. Like minus 1 and plus 1, they have multiplicative inverse. So we exclude them. Then among the remaining ones, those which cannot be factorized further, they are called prime numbers. But when I say factorization, I exclude plus minus 1, because for example, 5 I can factorize as plus 1 times 5 or minus 1 times minus 5. Now in this setup, these two factorizations, we don't call them different. Okay. And that way these negative numbers are also prime numbers. Minus 5 is also prime number, minus 7 is also prime number, minus 6 is not prime number.
Okay, thank you. Anupam da, next question to Aisha Dibangar Prako. Is prime number can be used to mine cryptocurrency?
Okay, so that I don't really know actually. Okay, so cryptocurrency is something that I have not really, yeah, so I don't know.
The last question so far is 15 minute hikkhar pray kono bhai khudi se. What is a
Mersenne prime?
Mersenne prime, yeah. Some
yeah, it is prime of some particular form. It's 2 to the power n plus 1 form. I think these are called Mersenne numbers. And when they happen to be prime, they are called Mersenne primes. So I think only 4 or 5 Mersenne primes are known, because they become very large after that. But examples have been found that not all numbers, not all Mersenne numbers are prime numbers. So Mersenne numbers basically 2 to the power n plus 1. Yeah, what do we know about the largest known prime number? Yeah, maybe I should have checked in Google and maybe should have found out the current status. But yeah, these are like very large primes are there. And of course, people, I think also there is like a prize also for finding big primes, because they have cryptographic application. But yeah, so I'll not be able to, yeah, say that. But yeah, these who can all, I don't know the present status, how big that prime is.
Anupam da, Facebook wala aur ek question aahi se, Unmi Bhattacharya. Sir, I have question apart from prime number theorem. Sir, can you please elaborate on Gauss curve by nonlinear multiple regression analysis? How to estimate the width, height, asymmetry of the curve?
Well, okay, no, that is, I'll be the wrong person to answer that question, I think, because I, yeah, maybe some statistics person will be able to do this. So, yeah. It's not my cup of tea.
So we have another question from one of our members. What is the easiest way to find prime numbers?
Easiest way to find prime numbers. Okay, I see. This is a very interesting question. And yeah, I don't have an answer to that, so to speak. Okay. Yeah, I don't have a ready-made answer for that. How you find that? Of course, it can be tested with AKS algorithm. Given a number, okay, then yeah. So
Anupam da, another question. Malika Roy khudise, can you explain the difference between relation and functions?
Okay, so a function is a special type of relation. Okay, every relation need not be a function. So when we say relation, what is a relation? It's like a subset. Okay, suppose I have like two sets A and B. Okay, or suppose if I want to define a relation on a set A, so it is a subset of the Cartesian product A cross A. Okay. So, but for a function, for every first element, the element that you associate has to be unique. Okay. In other words, in a relation, suppose I have three elements in a set, say 1, 2, 3. Now the relation can be like that one is related to two as well as one related to three. But a function, if I define a function, one can only go to two or one can only go to three. Okay, so that way you can say that the function is a special type of relation.
Hello.
Yes.
So team 15 minute hikha pra aru eta prashna ahise. You spoke about twin prime conjecture, right? Was it in the news recently that something big was solved about it?
Okay, so as I stated, twin prime conjecture means that there are infinitely many primes which differ by two. That means duta moulik sankha jar gap duir gapot akim sankhok moulik sankha ase mane to duir gapot mane ami jodi moulik sankha bur lo goi thako তেতিয়ালে গৈ এটা এটা সময়ৰ পাছত আমি এনেকুৱা দুটা মৌলিক সংখ্যা পাম, আমি যদি গোটেই মৌলিক সংখ্যাবোৰ লিষ্ট কৰি ললোঁ তেতিয়া কি হ'ব, আমি দেখিম যে দুইৰ গেপত অসংখ্য মৌলিক সংখ্যা থাকিব লাগে, সেইটো টুইন প্ৰাইম কনজেকচাৰে কৈছে। এণ্ড দ্য ৰিচেণ্ট প্ৰগ্ৰেছ ইজ দেট দুইৰ কাৰণে নহ'লেও 70 মিলিয়নৰ কাৰণে ইনফাইনাইটলি মেনি থাকিব, মানে দুইৰ গেপত ইনফাইনাইটলি মেনি প্ৰাইমছ মে অৰ মে নট বি দেয়াৰ ডেট উই ডোণ্ট ন' but we know that that the gap between this there will be infinitely many primes whose would differ by less than 70 million. That was Zhang's work. That was around 2013, and later on that was brought down to 246 as far as I know, and maybe it will come even further down. Okay, so maybe with some this can be further down. But yeah, 246 itself is a big achievement.
Anupam da, Malika Roy aru eta question hudise, what is 1-1 and onto function?
1-1 and onto function. Onto function means basically it's a surjective function, meaning suppose there is a function from A to B. If every element of B has a pre-image, that every element of B has a pre-image, then it's an onto function. And 1-1, okay, there are in two sense it is used, so that's why I want to clarify that one is basically, so that's why I prefer using surjective and injective. So 1-1 means one thing, that if the images are same, pre-images are same. Okay. So for example, if I take a map from natural number to natural number, that every number goes to twice that number, then that map is injective, or some books write it as 1-1. Okay, because if two times the numbers are same, the original numbers are same. But this map is not onto, because odd numbers will be left out, because I'm mapping 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 3 to 6. Okay, so that map is leaving out the odd numbers from the image, because 3 is not in the image of anything. So 3 is not 2 times some natural number. So
okay, Sangha, we have a question from Sanghamitra. Can we predict prime numbers?
Predict
or can we predict events prime
number. Okay, so as I would say that, okay, we know the probability because by prime number theorem, that if we take a very large number, then the probability is 1 by log n, okay, if the n is very large. Okay, so that much we can say, but that is just a probability. Okay.
So we have another question from Devanga. So he says that I have watched a YouTube video to output random numbers for making random password using Python programming language. So can we find bigger prime numbers using this process?
No, I don't know about this actually. So I will not be able to say.
Okay. So. So we have another request for you from one of our members. So if you can elaborate a little for the students today about your PhD thesis topic at Cambridge.
Okay, so my PhD thesis was about Iwasawa theory of limited division towers. So I would say that it will take some time, okay, maybe 5 minutes at least, that you have, okay, so today we talked about natural numbers or integers, but then we need to generalize, okay? Like we have the rational numbers. After that, we have rational numbers. What are rational numbers? One integer divided by a non-zero integer. Those are rational numbers. And of course, you know real numbers and complex numbers, but in between, there are lots of other number systems, okay? Because we know rational numbers, real numbers, and complex numbers, but in between there are some numbers which are known as algebraic numbers. What are algebraic numbers? They are roots of some polynomial with integer coefficient. For example, say square root of 3, square root of 5, or third root of 2. These are like algebraic numbers. Okay. Then what do we do with these algebraic numbers? So these algebraic numbers, we try to see whether the properties that we had for natural numbers, do they hold for, or the properties that we had for rational numbers, do they also work out for algebraic numbers, these numbers? Do we have unique factorization? Okay, you can see that unique factorization may not work. For example, 2 into 3 is 6, and 1 plus square root of minus 5, and 1 minus square root of minus 5, that is also 6. So 6 you are factorizing in two different ways. So certain things fail. So in other words, roughly speaking, that we study those algebraic numbers, that other structures. Okay, so that is algebraic number theory. And in Iwasawa theory, it is done over layers and layers of such numbers. Okay? It is over layers. Well, you have one layer, then another layer. For example, suppose you have square root of 2, then you have 4th root of 2, then you have 8th root of 2, then 16th root of 2. That way you get a tower of these structures. And Iwasawa theory, you study properties along this kind of towers. Okay. So roughly speaking, I would say that only.
Anupanda, another question by Mallika Roy. Can you please tell me about how to remember the trigonometric functions? I mean, how to learn by heart the formulas?
Okay, but I would not recommend learning mathematics by heart. I would say that you understand the concepts, and that's the best way to learn mathematics. And in the long run, that only helps. So certainly, and I guess you, once you get very involved with what you are doing with this mathematical, mathematical formulas even. And of course, and you can always derive. I guess only one thing needs to be known, maybe what is sine theta, if you know, then other things are in some sense natural. Even if you remember something, then other thing can be derived. And it may be time consuming to derive everything from the definition. And in the beginning, it may take time, but I think it is the correct way to learn mathematics. They try to derive, try to remember as little as possible, but try to work out. At least I'm not saying that you do it one day before exams or something, because exams are important here. But certainly if you are in class 8 or 9, certainly you have the time to work out whatever formula. Why sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1, or if y, if you know sin theta equal to 1 by 2, then you can always get all the values just by, I mean, you can work out everything else. A lot of things can be worked out if we just, and even y sin theta, when y sin pi by 6 is half, that also you can work out by geometry. So I think that is the way to, that is the thing that you can work out. I mean, you have the tools, you just have to, of course, like, you cannot keep doing that because there will be a finite amount of time. But once you keep practicing, then those things, and if you are doing it in an involved way, but if you are trying to do it like minimize your work and you just somehow get it done, then that way, that doesn't help.
Okay, we have another question here, a specific one. Is there an application of prime numbers, particularly in nuclear physics?
In
nuclear physics.
Well, no, I don't know, actually. I will not be able to say. I doubt it, but I cannot rule it out certainly.
Okay. With this, I think we have, okay, we have another question has just come up from Navajit Barman. Among IIT, CMI, and TIFR, which institute is better for research in maths in India?
Okay. Oh, okay. If you say research, okay, yes. Certainly TIFR certainly was the most significant or prestigious or the leading institute, and probably still is. And yeah, I think it is the one that is the best. And certainly CMI is also a very good institute. Yeah.
Anupamda, how about ISIs?
Yeah, they are also good. I think in that order, probably, I should not say it. I mean, depends on the subject also, even the subdivisions. I mean, which branch, which area of mathematics that way. But yeah, by and large, if I have to make a statement, I'd say that TIFR, maybe after that, maybe CMI and IMSC, those are, and IISc, and is. Then ISI Kolkata, for example, it's very good.
So, okay, Anupam. Anupam. So suppose I ask you, sir, please give the names of five best mathematicians of our country. So who will say?
Okay, who five best mathematicians of our country.
Country, of course, at this moment.
Oh, at this moment.
At this moment.
Okay. I mean, recently some great mathematicians passed away, like Seshadri and Narasimhan. They were certainly.
Seshadri, yeah.
Seshadri and Narasimhan, they were very highly regarded mathematicians. So we can probably still include them because Narasimhan just passed away a few weeks back. And then of course we have to mention Professor Raghunathan. Professor Raghunathan. And yeah, there are many others, maybe Professor Balasubramaniam and Dipendra Prasad. There are many actually, so it is very, and of course, Ritabhatra Munshi and Mohan Maharaj, they are very, it's difficult to actually limit the list to five. One has to actually think really a lot, and then still it's very difficult to come up with these five names.
Okay, thank you. This is very difficult. But
Seshadri and Narasimhan, without any this thing that one can say.
Heard about Seshadri, but didn't heard about Narasimhan.
Because they did a lot of things collaboratively also, and
okay, we have another question from one student, Devanga again. So he is very much worried about the current situation, and he's saying that online classes are not sufficient for learning mathematics or such subjects like physics. How can we overcome it? So it's there.
Yeah, it is really unfortunate that what is happening. But I suppose now it is a matter of time, maybe 6 more months and maybe things will improve. But in the meanwhile, of course, the good thing is there's so much material available, YouTube or internet and all. I guess the difficulty is in filtering, which is useful because certainly there is abundance of material. So now the difficulty is which one is most beneficial or, you needed probably a customized things like so that what is required that you can learn. Yeah, I guess one has to rely on good books because the good books, I think one can learn a lot from good books because I think, I think it's because, for example, mathematics, how you learn. I feel that one has to read the book and then work out the problems. That's the best way to learn mathematics. Similarly for physics, I suppose, because you can read the book. The books are there, so you read, and then you try to work out as much as possible because everything is there in the book. And if someone teaches, he is also relying on those books only. So just that, you may have to work a bit more, but then your understanding will be clearer. It will be more rewarding in some sense, because when you struggle, then you your understanding becomes clearer. But if someone else does it, maybe it is quicker, but it is not deeper. So I would say that it will require more effort, more time, but also you'll get a deeper understanding. And you have to believe in your own work and own ability. And of course, you can trace out whatever doubts, because it may happen that you may get an opportunity to talk, but for a little time. So we have to be very clear about what you did not understand. For example, I think one mistake we make sometimes, that we make very general statements that we don't understand physics, for example. Or say, let's talk about maths. Okay, suppose we don't understand maths. Okay, rather than this generalized statement, we can say that, okay, in mathematics, which part actually I don't understand? Okay, maybe then you point out, maybe algebra actually. The algebra is the thing that I'm... Then if from algebra, okay, in algebra, what is the thing that I don't understand that well? Okay, maybe I do not understand the theory of equations. Okay, you go to theory of equations. Then you see, okay, in theory of equations, which thing actually I do not really understand? And if I find, okay, this is like the cubic equation, what is the property of roots or relation of roots to coefficients? Then you go to that, and then when you go finer and finer, and you'll be able to pinpoint accurately what you actually do not understand. And that is the biggest step in understanding, because once you, from a vague statement that you don't understand mathematics, once you can go to that accurate statement that you did not understand the relation between the roots of a cubic equation with its coefficients, then already that is a big achievement, I think. Then after that, you can clear that with someone or some of your friend or something, and you can put questions. Nowadays, there are so many forums one can ask questions. Okay, so I would say that refine your questions as much as possible.
Dr. Anupam. That was a very good piece of advice, actually, and it holds good for any subjects, not only mathematics. Yeah. So first, you should know what you do not know. Then it becomes easier for you to understand. Okay. Then we have another question from Jiten Chaudhary. I have always wondered about the relationship between abstract algebra and tensor. So can you elaborate on this, sir?
Okay, so tensor, as I understand, it will require algebra, because it's like a, so to speak, quotient structure of like modules. Okay, so if we think tensor product of modules, it's like you have certain relations, like the linearity and other things. And I would say that to have a proper understanding of tensors, I know the abstract way only, actually. So I would say that, this theory of modules, what are the properties that you are expecting? Okay, what are the properties that you expect? For example, A plus B tensor C should be A tensor C plus B tensor C. Okay, then that way, like some basic properties you expect, then you can force it on a structure by taking quotient. That is the mathematical way of doing it. And then, or there is a way of seeing it as converting a bilinear map to a linear map. Okay, that is one way of looking at it. And of course, this is best understood through books of algebra. For example, there might be other texts also, but by the book by Atiyah and MacDonald, that is certainly good, but maybe not for undergraduate level, but So I guess to understand it in the abstract sense, maybe at least first course in algebra is certainly required, after that only.
Thank you. Thank you, Anupamda. Mukul Bora at a prosna khudise. Sir, 0/0 is not defined or infinite. Some teachers say it is infinite.
Okay. So what I can say is that, see, okay, let's see. What is 0? 0 is 1 times 0, 2 times 0, 5 times 0, 7 times 0. So if I take 0 is 5 times 0, then 0/0 becomes 5. I mean, if traditionally. Or if I view it 0 as 0 times 10, then 0/0 becomes 10 also. That's why it is better to say it is undefined, which is different from 1/0 in some sense, because 1/0 you can say that it is infinite, because 1/0 we can view it as like limit of 1/x as x goes to 0. And of course depends whether it goes from the positive side or negative side. If like say if x is like 0.00001, then 1/0.00001 is like something big but positive. But if it is minus 0.00 something, then it is minus infinity. But at least we can make some sense out of it. But 0/0, we can actually give it, that does not fit in. So, and by the way, I guess one should know why do we say that A times 0 is 0? Okay. If you think about it, it comes from distributivity. That A times 0 is A times 0 plus 0. And if you apply distributive law, it is like A times 0 plus A times 0. So A times 0 becomes A times 0 plus A times 0. So A times 0 is 0. Okay, so that way, 10 times 0 is 0. But 0/0, we cannot say this theory.
Thank you. Mukul Borare, Prishnath Arvata Prasna, he said. In general, sir, what did Ramanujan do for mathematics? Why we know him as one of the greatest mathematician? What was his research?
Okay, that's a very good question. And of course, yeah, I think as Indians, we must know the contribution is contribution of Ramanujan, who is so highly regarded. And I would mention a few things. For example, he studied partition numbers. So what are partition numbers? Like, for example, say let's take 5. 5 you can write as 5. Or 4 plus 1, or 3 plus 2, or 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, or you write 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So that means you're partitioning. Okay, so 5, you have partitioned in these many ways. So Ramanujan did many things, but one of the things is studying these partition numbers. He predicted how they will behave, many properties of partition functions he proved, some of them with Hardy. Okay, so roughly speaking, and of course some of the things Ramanujan did was like just then made people think about more generally, and then lot of things got developed from there. Okay, so that way he contributed a lot to the theory of modular forms also. And of course the thing is that we all know that how like he did not have much formal education and all, and he did not know actually how to write a proof, but he could know what is true actually. I mean, he knew the theorem, but only that he did not write the steps, how he arrived at those statements. So it's very surprising. He had like thousands of formulas, okay, thousands of like series, infinite series, like many infinite series are there, like what is their sum, he knew. But how he obtained that, it was like a mysterious, I mean, so it is like people are so fascinated by Ramanujan.
So Devanga has another question on Ramanujan. So actually he is a bit confused about it. Ramanujan knew the infinity, but what it actually means? Someone has told me Ramanujan knew infinite theory. Is this the actual answer or anything else?
So I guess it is meant a bit metaphorically, I suppose, that he knew infinity. I would say, yeah, I think it is not mathematically in that sense that, okay, I mean, I think it is just metaphorical, and that he knew so much, probably, that he knew, and maybe he had some connection with something that normal human beings did not have access to, because he used to attribute all his work to the goddess Namakkal. Okay, so maybe he had
So in between, actually, we have missed one concern from one parent. So he is saying that if a class 12 student complains I understand when the teacher explains it, but when I am asked to do a sum, I fumble and get confused. Any suggestions for such students how to rectify to the approach to learn mathematics?
Yeah, so I think we build the wrong habits from school days, I would say. My understanding is that because by the time they come to class 11 or 12, they already have some habits where like how they learned in schools. Many people, I think, do not work problems out themselves, but they are given a solution. মানে এটা solution দি দিলে আৰু তাৰ পিছত চাই পেলাই বাকি কিটা কৰা হল গতিকে কি হল তাৰ কাৰণে কিছুমান যেনেকে চিন্তাৰ বিকাশ হ'ব লাগিছিলে so that thought process did not develop. Now what happens in class 11 and 12, time is a bit less because the syllabus is more, and then that's how they struggle, I think. But I think the solution is that one has to basically put in extra time and practice more, and students must feel motivated, because once students are motivated, then a lot of things they will do on their own also. So I think it is not easy. Certainly it is a very difficult task, because if you have someone in class 5 and 6, you can do a lot more, 5, 6, 7, 8, or even 9, 10. But 11, 12, already some habits are formed. And secondly, because in our system that we are having, this 11 and 12, they are turning out to be so crucial for admission and other things. So many concerns are there. So that learning, unfortunately, takes a backseat in the sense that the performance becomes unfortunately very important and learning. But still, I would say that even in class 11, it can be done, I suppose, that the student has to work it out. There are solved examples. They should go step by step. Suppose in a mathematical problem, we have to go to A to Z, suppose. Now, we have to find a way or step by step, we can check. Suppose some problem, okay, suppose the student is struggling, doesn't even know where to start. So he can, okay, maybe look up at the solved example first, that how this step is done. Okay, then he tries to, from there on, he should try to carry on his own argument. Then if he gets stuck again, see that step and again continue. And I think that process, it is time consuming, but at least you'll see where the difficulty lies. Otherwise, I think this is a practice. I will say that it comes out of practice and patience and hard work.
Yeah, thank you, Anupam, for your advice. We have another that sort of question from Santono. Sir, I'm studying in BSc fourth semester, but I faced much difficulty to understanding real analysis.
So I would say that always read the good books. Okay, always read, because it happens in India. I've seen people, they write books on algebra as well as analysis and all range of subjects. But I think whereas some other books are there, people just write one book in 10 years. And certainly those books are written in a very measured way and with a lot of effort and all. So I think, and particularly analysis is a subject that one has to give time, and one has to, then rigor is very important, because one has to justify in mathematical analysis, real analysis, you have to justify. Intuitively, something may seem true, but then it may turn out to be false. So it is very important to, and it is brick by brick. Like if you don't understand the definition of sequence properly, or what is convergence of sequence, then you'll struggle with convergence of series. And then you'll also, and if you struggle with this definition of limit, or what is the limit, what it means, then suddenly all this derivative and all other things, or mean value theorem, or all other things that one cannot make up, I mean, there'll be always big gaps. So even if it takes more time, it's better to learn the basics very thoroughly in analysis. Okay, I think that's the way. And one has to read good books in analysis. Particularly, one has to be very careful. So I feel there are some classic texts, and one has to, and work out. Look at the solved example. You try to work it out yourself and see where you are actually, if you are having a departure. Of course, you may be correct, but you can see what is the way the book has explained it. So I would say that the solved examples, they is like a that is like the testing ground. I mean, you test what you're understanding with the solved examples first. You don't look at the whole solution completely. You just take the problem, solve example, I mean, and try to solve it yourself. And then if you cannot solve it, then step by step, you take help from the solved example. Then you can test whatever, okay, this is, then you can, I think, identify where drawback is. Okay. So I would say that, yeah. So it's a very important subject. And yeah, rigor one has to learn.
Thank you, Anupam da. Actually, our Satra Satri Hokolo Desi Kosu, our 15 minute Hikar website to books, reference books, or Karna at a tab assay. We'll request Anupam Saikia, Dr. Anupam Saikia, to give us some advice on some of the books so that we'll upload those names in the website so that you can refer them also for different mathematical. I think our question is, Kekhoise, Munimaba, please conclude for you, sir.
Okay, yeah, so. I just thought, okay, so maybe because this is also a new experience for me. Mukarne wada na tuno bikota. Gudike mohi kenege kollo mohi nizeo thik gompo nae. Aru hoto jodi kisman kotha alab lahake kabo lagisile ba khorke kabo lagisile ba khomiyat bisiye kabo lagisile. Gudike ekto mohi thik dhugo mane gudike tarbabe mohi. I'm sorry for that. Jodi I connect you off with all, but yeah, and thank you for your attention. And I'd like to thank everyone. And then, of course, 15 minute hikar jugedi ami neke aru video dibole sam jate amar satra satriokolor kamot ahake keneke ami koibo paru karon amar iccha pura ase amar Rifada Hironoda amar gote team de Pavan Soria sir Munima Baidu Angamitra Goswami Prohenjit Nilkamal Kollan aru amar Mittaur ase Amanna Asami sobore amar intention to hetu khali ami then how we have to see how we can make it relevant and useful to you. Are you meaning the students that okay, so we'll try to do that, and we of course we'll have to evolve. Maybe there's a better way. Maybe we should do it this way or that way, or maybe we should do more in Assamese. Okay, there are other things that we have to try. It is just we're just starting out. So you bear with us, and maybe you can advise us, because I'm sure, like in the YouTube page, tumalke ki bisarisa ba ki bisarile tumalke upokrito ba hetu amak janabolai karon ami eta dhana koiloi ami tumalok kisuman kotha dibule saisu kintu tumalke actually bhalke janibo je tumalok asolote ki lage ar hetu amak janabolai bojate ami jikini korisu tar kiba ta harthokota thake otike সেইখিনি তোমালোকে আমাক হেল্প কৰিলে আমি বেছি ভালকে গম পাম যেনেকে আমাৰ কিছুমান ধাৰণা আছে যে আগলে উচ্চ শিক্ষাৰ কাৰণে বোলে বিদেশলৈ কেনেকে যাব পাৰি কিন্তু আমাৰ ডক্টৰ প্ৰসেনজিত খনিকৰে কোৱাৰ কথা আছে আজাতে তাৰ আগতে আমাৰ হাই ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলে আণ্ডাৰ গ্ৰেজুৱেট পৰ্যায়ত কি কৰা উচিত বা আণ্ডাৰ গ্ৰেজুৱেটৰখিনিয়ে হায়াৰ ষ্টাডিজৰ কাৰণে ইণ্ডিয়াৰ ভিতৰতো কি কৰা উচিত বা কেনেকুৱা কেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ কেৰিয়াৰ অপশ্যন আছে সেইটো আমাৰ অলৰেডি নীলকমলে বহুত ধুনীয়াকৈ কৈ গৈছে কেমেষ্ট্ৰি কি কি কেৰিয়াৰ প্ৰস্পেক্ট আছে গতিকে তেনেকুৱা কথাবিলাক হয়তো কোৱাৰো বহুতখিনি প্ৰয়োজনীয়তা আছে বুলি অনুভৱ আমাৰ ধাৰণা আৰু কি কি কৰিলে ভাল হ'ব এইটো তোমালোকে জনালে বেছি ভাল পাম গতিকে মই দীঘলীয়া নকৰোঁ মই সকলোকে বহুতো ধন্যবাদ জনাইছো
এখিনিতে মই এটা কমেণ্ট পঢ়ি দিব বিচাৰিছো সায়ন নন্দীয়ে কৈছে যে আজি জুমত হোৱা এই আলোচনাৰ পৰা মই খুবেই উপকৃত হৈছো মোৰ গণিতৰ প্ৰতি যথেষ্ট আগ্ৰহ বৃদ্ধি হৈছে সায়ন আমি এই কথাটো জানিবলৈ পাই অত্যন্ত সুখী হৈছো কাৰণ তোমালোকে যদি উপকৃত হোৱা সেইটোৱে আমাৰ কাৰণে এটা ডাঙৰ সফলতা তেওঁ আৰু জনাইছে মই গণিত অথবা অন্যান্য বিষয় সম্বন্ধীয় কিছুমান প্ৰশ্ন পাওঁ আপুনি এনে কোনো মাধ্যম এইটো ডক্টৰ অনুপম শইকীয়া সুধিছে আপুনি এনে কোনো মাধ্যম আমাক জনাব পাৰিব নেকি যাৰ জৰিয়তে আমি আপোনাৰ সংযোগত থাকিব পাৰোঁ আৰু এনেবোৰ প্ৰশ্নৰ উত্তৰ পাব পাৰোঁ
মই ভাবোঁ যে হয়তো আমাৰ মিপটাউৰে বা ৰিফাদাই হয়তো আমাৰ ফৰামৰ যোগেদি হয়তো যদি কিবা ব্যৱস্থা হ'ব পাৰে হয়তো আমি সেইটো ভাবিম বাৰু তেওঁলোকে যেতিয়া কোৱা হৈছে যে আমি প্ৰশ্নৰ কিবা যদি আমাৰ শিতান এনেকে ৰাখিব পৰা যায় নেকি
আমাৰ ৱেবছাইটৰ জৰিয়তে হয়তো
ৱেবছাইটৰ জৰিয়তে যদি কৰিব পৰা যায় সেইটো ভাল হ'ব
আমাৰ
ৱেবছাইটতে
দেবাংগই আচলতে সেই কথাটোৱে কৈছে যে 15 মিনিট শিক্ষা এটা অনলাইন গ্ৰুপ বনাব পাৰিব নেকি যাতে সকলো ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰী উপকৃত হয় আমি এনে ধৰণৰ ডাউট হলে আপোনালোকক সুধিব পাৰো সো তেওঁৰ কথাটো তেনেকুৱাই যে আমি তেওঁলোকক মানে ডাউট ক্লিয়াৰ কৰাত বা কিবা প্ৰশ্ন থাকিলে পোনপটীয়াকৈ উত্তৰ দিয়াত বিয়ণ্ড দিছ ছেশ্যনছ সহায় কৰিব পাৰিম ভৱিষ্যতে আৰু মুকুল বৰা এটা ৰিকুৱেষ্ট কৰিছিলে নেক্সট ক্লাছত গোল্ডেন ৰেচিঅ বিষয়ে কব নেকি
মানে আমাৰ এতিয়া এনেকুৱা হ'ব যে এতিয়া আমি গণিতটো আমাৰ যিটো ধাৰণা আৰু মই মানে মই যিখিনি বুজিছো যে আমি এতিয়া গণিতৰ ওপৰত এনেকে ক'লো তাৰপিছত আকৌ নেক্সট আমি এটা বেলেগ এটা বিষয়লৈ যাম তাৰোপৰি আকৌ কিছুমান প্ৰেক্টিকেল কিছুমান গাইডেন্স যাতে আমি দিব পাৰোঁ তেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ নিশ্চয় আমি আকৌ যেতিয়া মেথছলৈ ঘূৰি আহিম তেতিয়া আমি ভাবি চাম যে আমি কি বিষয় দিলে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকল বেছিকৈ উপকৃত হ'ব গতিকে আমি সেইটো চাব লাগিব সেইমতে আমি কৰিম যেনে যেনেকে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰী কামত আহে সেনেকে ধৰণে
আমি সকলো ইয়াত উপস্থিত থকা আজি ডিজিটেল প্লেটফৰ্মত উপস্থিত থকা সকলো ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰী আৰু অন্যান্যসকলক ধন্যবাদ জনাইছোঁ আৰু বিশেষকৈ ধন্যবাদ জনাইছোঁ ডক্টৰ অনুপম শইকীয়াক যোনে অতি সুন্দৰভাৱে তেখেতৰ ক'বলগীয়াখিনি ক'লে লেকচাৰটো আমাৰ আগত আকৌ এবাৰ দিলে আৰু প্ৰশ্নবোৰৰো পোনপটীয়া উত্তৰ দিলে ব্যাখ্যা কৰিলে সকলোখিনি কথা গতিকে আমি তেখেতক আমাৰে মাজৰে এজন সদস্য তেখেতক তথাপিও আমি পুনৰবাৰ ধন্যবাদ জনাইছোঁ ইমানখিনি সময় ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলৰ কাৰণে দিয়াৰ কাৰণে এইখিনিতে মই এটা সৰুকৈ এটা এনাউন্সমেণ্ট কৰিব বিচাৰিছোঁ যে অহাবাৰ আমাৰ এই 15 মিনিট শিক্ষা এই প্লেটফৰ্মত যিটো প্ৰগ্ৰেম হ'ব আমাৰ সেইটো হ'ব ফিজিক্সত পিছৰ বিষয়বস্তুটো আমাৰ ফিজিক্স আৰু তাত আইজাৰ ত্ৰিবান্দমৰ তেখেতে তাতে সহযোগী অধ্যাপক হিচাপে কাম কৰি আছে তেখেতৰ নাম অমল মেধি তেখেতে কোৱাণ্টাম ৱৰ্ল্ডখনৰ বিষয়ে আমাক কিছু কথা জনাব চ' ইট উড বি বেচিকেলি অন আৱাৰ ফাৰ্ষ্ট ইণ্টাৰেকশ্যন অৰ ফাৰ্ষ্ট এনকাউণ্টাৰ উইথ দ্য কোৱাণ্টাম ৱৰ্ল্ড চ' মই ভাবোঁ সেইটো আমাৰ ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলৰ কাৰণে খুবেই ইণ্টাৰেষ্টিং হ'ব তেওঁলোকে ভাল পাব কথাখিনি শুনি সেইকাৰণে মই আজি ইয়াত যিখিনি ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰী উপস্থিত আছা তোমালোকক মই অনুৰোধ জনাইছোঁ তোমালোকে 27 জুনত হ'ব সেইটো ইয়াৰ পিছৰ দেওবাৰৰ পিছৰ দেওবাৰটো মাজত এটা দেওবাৰ এৰি 27 জুনত হ'ব চ' তোমালোকে উপস্থিত থাকিবা তোমালোক ফিজিক্সৰ ষ্টুডেণ্ট নহ'লেও তোমালোকে মই যিটো অনুমান কৰিছোঁ তোমালোকে সেই বিষয়টোৰ বিষয়ে জানিবলৈ পাই ভাল পাবা জানিবলৈ ভাল পাবা আৰু লগতে তোমালোকৰ যিখিনি লগৰীয়া আছে যোন ফিজিক্স যোনে ফিজিক্স পঢ়ি আছে বা অন্যান্য বিষয়ৰ যাৰ বিভিন্ন কথা জানিবলৈ ইচ্ছা আছে তেওঁলোকক এই কথাটো জনাবা যে 27 তাৰিখে আমাৰ ফিজিক্সত কোৱাণ্টাম ৱৰ্ল্ডৰ বিষয়ে এটা আলোচনা চক্ৰ হ'ব আৰু তাতে তোমালোকে তোমালোকৰ কিবা কথা যদি জানিবলৈ আছে তেনেহ'লে জানিবৰ সুবিধা পাবা তেখেতৰ পৰা এইখিনি কৈ আজি আমাৰ এই অনুষ্ঠানটো সামৰণি মাৰিছো ইফ ৰিফাত হেজ সাম কনক্লুডিং কমেন্টস ইউ ক্যান প্লিজ গিভ
অ নাই নাই থ্যাংক ইউ মুনিমা নাই থ্যাংক ইউ অনুপম থ্যাংক ইউ অল স্টুডেন্টস
অনুপম থ্যাংক ইউ অনুপম সো মাচ
থ্যাংক ইউ বঢ়িয়া হৈছে অনুপম
ভাল লাগিলে
থ্যাংক ইউ অনুপম দা থ্যাংক ইউ
অনুপম দা ভাল লাগিলে
পিয়া হাই
আৰু
এটা লেকচাৰ জইন কৰিম নেকি